Everything is working, everybody. Yes, we are live again. Welcome back to Online Olympia 2020. My name is Roland, Roland Pruisers, and I'm here once again, of course, with Anna Muzyciuk. Yeah, we're down for round two of this whole commentary session this day. How are you feeling, Anna?
I feel great. Thank you. Hello, everyone. Welcome to all the new viewers, and also welcome to all the old viewers who are watching us from starting from the morning. Yeah, we are commentating on Division 2 of FIDE Online Chess Olympiad. Pool A has finished all the games for today, and we are going to Pool B.
Yeah, and let's show that immediately on the board. So, well, actually not on the board, on the left of the board. So, yeah, Pool B already started. And as you can see, here are the round four results. Greece winning, Israel winning their match, Austria winning their match, Singapore winning their match, and Romania. And also round five happened in during the break. So here you go. Also, that those results are here. Slovakia, Greece, a tie. Romania beating Thailand 6-0. Austria losing to Singapore 2-4. Israel, IPCA 3-3. Good result, I think, for IPCA. And then Moldova winning 4.5, 1.5 versus Latvia. So what are the standings, you might ask? Well, we've got the answer ready for you. Here you go. Romania is the current leader with 9 points. Then we've got Greece and Slovakia with respectively 8 and 7 points. And of course, other countries are still in the race as well, like Moldova, Israel, Latvia, and Singapore. They still have a very good chance, of course, to qualify. All right, so, and then to make to finish this whole circle, what are the matches for round six? These are the ones that we are going to cover in this broadcast. Well, actually, in this 1 hour, and here you go. We've got Greece versus Moldova, IPCA versus Latvia, Singapore versus Israel, Romania versus Austria, and Slovakia versus Thailand. Is there any match that catches your eye, Anna?
I believe that Greece versus Moldova is like the very important match because these two teams are fighting to qualify into qualifying to the top division, so that in order to do that, you have to be in the top three. And Greece had a very important match in the previous round. That match was versus Slovakia. Once again, reminding, Greece is on place two at the moment, Slovakia is on place three. So this was a very important match in the previous round, as it ended in a draw 3-3.
Yeah, very important result. So both did a good job with that draw. I don't think it matters too much so far for the standings. A draw is fine for both teams. And yeah, Greece-Moldova, definitely the match to look out for. So let me also check then if we can find the games, if they already started. And it seems that they are starting, not that far progressed ahead. Actually, I recognize this opening, and also the player, by the way, Victor Bologan, was very kind to join us in a previous broadcast to share his thoughts about the tournament. So that was a lovely experience for us. And we've seen this opening before, haven't we, Anna? But this time with the queen on c2 instead of on h5.
I remember correctly, we started our first stream with exactly the same opening and with a very similar position. While yes, in that game, in the first game, white did go queen h5, and then in this game white went queen c2, which I mentioned was like the main move in this line.
Yep. So h5, knight e2. This is actually the first board of the, of course, the big match, Greece versus Moldova. And yeah, once again, a reminder, everybody, the ratings that you see next to the names are the chess.com ratings, not the official FIDE ratings. So keep that in mind. The chess.com ratings are usually not a good representative of the official rating. So there you go. Keep that in mind. Victor Bologan has about 2650 rating, if I'm not mistaken. So, yeah, and Dimitrios Mastrovasilis has about 2,600 or something close to that, if I'm not mistaken. So, okay, yeah, so black plays rook e8, and white actually went for short castle. I don't think that's usually the approach. I think usually white plays bishop e3, long castle, and then they try to make something going on the king side. Or am I maybe mistaken here, Anna? I'm not too sure about this, actually.
In fact, I think that both of the plans with short castle and with a long castle are possible. I myself played with the long castle, and once I tried with a short castle too. But there was one trick. The last move was queen c7, actually not allowing queen bishop f4. But I can say that bishop f4 was not possible anyway, because even in case black played, let's say h4, which is a typical move in this type of structure, in case white goes with bishop f4, yeah, then there is this nice trick with rook e2, and then we take the bishop on e f4. Still, we have to be careful with some ideas like queen e4, maybe.
Yeah.
Maybe it's actually not clear, so but just, yeah, please keep this trick in mind.
Yeah, it's a good trick to mention. I'm not too sure about what the evaluation is here. Let's say after bishop h6, queen h7, king f8, and now, yeah, queen h8 is met by king e7, but maybe you can start with rook e1.
Maybe another rook. I want to play rook e1, and if bishop e6, then f4. F5.
Yeah, this looks very, very dangerous for black indeed. Yeah, but it's a good trick to keep in mind. In some calculation variations, this is very, very good for black, but right now it doesn't work, and that shows the importance of how to do calculations. So yeah, there you go. But anyways, h4 not played, black played queen c7, which was a very logical move to prevent bishop f4, which maybe was actually possible in hindsight, but now it's forever stopped. And so, unless you play g3, but that leaves some white squares open in the kingside position. So I like queen c7, very good move. And h3 played, black was attacking that pawn, and now knight d7. So if I'm not mistaken, then the knight is supposed to go to f8, just be, well, chilling like a villain on f8 for the longest time. And then they will play something like bishop e6, maybe b5, bishop d5, try to keep everything as solid as possible and hope for white to overpush at some point. Is that a good summary, Anna? I'm not too sure. I haven't played this very often, but...
Yeah, knight f8, bishop e6 is the plan. Then sometimes even the ideas like queen d7 is threatening bishop h3 sacrifice. One more plan for black is to play c5 at some moment. Depending on what white is doing, and then black is taking the actions. Knight g3 is played. Is it possible to win the pawn? I am not sure, because it's actually quite dangerous. If black takes on g3, then bishop f4 and queen is a bit trapped. But how to trap the queen? Maybe directly g3, queen takes, and bishop f5. And we reach the target. Nice.
We do. Now we could keep going a little bit, because
yeah, rook
e2 is still available. But with the queen coming to e8, knight f... Oh, wait, actually, this is a mistake.
Bishop d6.
Yeah, so now you have to play this move. Queen takes f7 is possible. This is just looking really, really good for white. Although, if black can somehow consolidate, then black still has chances. But it should be clear that white's on top here, right?
I don't think black should take the pawn on g3. So it's another idea you may use in your games. Knight g3, and it's not that this pawn can be taken.
So how do you defend against knight takes h5 then? Because if you play g6, then white has the quick bishop takes g6. That should be very, very dangerous. So how are you going h4? To protect this h5 pawn?
If h4, then knight f5 is coming.
Yeah, and you don't want to play a move like g5?
Oh, no. Knight d6 and f4. No, don't do that, please.
F4, this is looking really, really dangerous. Yeah, white's gonna have a blast trying to get the king side open. This is why you don't push your king side pawns, your pawns in front of your king. You could get countered big time. Every time I say big time, I'm reminded of how too big for some reason. Okay, he's here, so I have a laugh, my friend. All right, here we go. Knight g3, and then what else? Yeah, how? I don't know. You have to take maybe. Otherwise, you lose a pawn on h5. But maybe you sacrifice that pawn and play just c5 to try. It's a dangerous position. I like white for some reason.
I think
Let's
it's
see.
a cool approach from white side. So maybe black did play some inaccurate moves
Yeah,
before,
maybe.
but maybe not. Maybe it's still okay.
Yeah, black took on g3, f takes g3, and now I'm 100% sure he's not going to take here. But then white has, I think, a very good position with bishop f4 coming, rook e1, maybe try to attack this pawn on h5. But okay, black is very solid, so white does need to somehow find a way to break through here. But okay, I think we've been talking for kind of a long, a lot of minutes already on this game. So let's move on to board two in this match, the big match in this pool right now. Ooh.
Ooh, quick king on C2. You saw that, right?
Yep. Before we do anything else, what black is a pawn up for the moment. It's black to move. Black cannot castle. The bishop cannot move. Ugh. What do you make of this? I don't know. Queen e5, maybe even knight takes e4 is possible.
Yeah,
This
knight
very
e4 is
much
a
looks
threat.
like.
Because
Yeah.
now white wants to take on e4, knight e4, and perhaps queen f3 or queen g4, win the piece back. Yeah, any place. Queen d3, queen f5, queen f3, queen g4.
Yeah. I don't know. I think, what would I like? I guess queen g4 would be my preference, because then you can take with the rook. Yeah, you can also take here with the rook, but then you've got rook d8, and if you go here, then you've got g6. Your queen gets chased away. I just like to put it on g4, and then h5 is a bad move because of queen g6. So, anyways, enough about that. This is a big threat here, and of course, black will not play rook b8. That's not a good move. If anything, rook d8 is the better move there. But yeah, I
Did
think.
the same, and rook d8, maybe it's the same. Knight e4 is coming after almost any
I
black
think so
supply.
too. I don't see a way for white to stop knight takes e4. Well,
King
unless you want to be cheeky and
but
say, ha, after e3, you can't take on e4 because the pawn is on e3.
good morning.
Good morning. Yeah. So, black's in trouble, I think. I don't see a clear way out to continue for black. What do you have any brilliant ideas?
Me neither. Maybe trying to trade the queens with queen d7, but then it's just better for white. Yeah, still knight e4. Queen h3, knight f6. Yeah. King
Double
f7.
attack, so the king has to move. Guess just take. If g takes, you already lose. If king takes, then the king is absolutely exposed, even against two rooks without a queen. So the king is still very much unsafe. So white is having a field day here. Yeah, very tough position. Yeah, looking very good for white. This king c2 move is pretty creative. I like it. Maybe even preparation, because look at the time difference as well. It's 13 minutes 46 versus 6 minutes for black. So black is in quite a lot of trouble here.
What was the opening? How did it arise?
Yeah, I was thinking this was some sort of Janisch, but it's actually a Steinitz variation with a quick f5, I believe. That's how it's called, right?
Advanced Steinitz, because with
Yeah,
A6.
with a6, advanced Steinitz with a6, yeah. F5, very famous opening, I believe. You take, play.
D4,
Oh, yeah.
E4. I believe it's still the line. D5. And now I'm not so much familiar with the theory, but computer doesn't like it for some reason.
I'm trying to figure out why.
Was queen a7 bad? Let's check. Maybe it was okay. King
King
d1.
d1, exclamation point. For some reason, I don't know. I don't know. So I'm trying to
Maybe
think of
bishop d1,
something.
if we take that piece.
I think it's connected with. Oh, yes, you're right. That's it. It's bishop takes b1, rook takes b5.
But
And you lose a piece.
I was
Sorry?
also thinking if after bishop b1, it takes c6.
Yep. But then
b5.
once again, b5, right?
If bishop b3, we have the check on e7 now.
Ah, that's true too. Yeah, queen
Bishop g6.
e7. I was planning to play bishop g6 to stop queen f7 mates, but wow, really, 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 really. Actually, maybe it's then better to first play b5. Is that an idea? My idea was if queen takes here, then knight
B5, knight e7.
c7.
Nice.
If you moved on bishop here, then also knight c7.
Then there are
But
plenty of possibilities.
you can take here. And then take here, and then bishop b7, and you got the same position. But maybe this is the reason why the computer is not really agreeing with us. I guess why it still has a lot of compensation after all of this, but it should be something like that. Yeah, that would be my best guess, simply.
Anyway, what was played? Queen e7 was played in d1 exclamation mark.
Boom, 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 boom. And white won the piece back, more or less. Yeah.
Okay, and now can see too. Okay,
Yeah.
crazy
That's how
line,
we were. Yeah,
but very
crazy line.
exciting.
I don't think both players played perfectly in the opening, but it was at least very entertaining. And Mr. Iordachescu is a famous player from Romania, so I'm sure he worked this out maybe at home, or he, I don't know. I have huge respect for him, anyways. That's all I'm
Queen
saying, I
d7,
guess.
by the way, was played in the game. Knight e4, the most we suggested, and long castle, but not just the queen trade, and white has very pleasant position.
Yeah,
Bishop
very pleasant.
advantage,
So,
also
yeah.
taking on f6, so the pawn structure will also be in white's favor. Just
Yeah,
nice.
it's very, very nice. Actually, after bishop takes e6, the whole pawn structure is going to be destroyed. So white will have a very pleasant end game with all of this. All right, let's move on to board three.
Board three. Wow, what's that?
This is looking absolutely
White.
brilliant for white,
White
I
has a
probably would say.
domination. If I is threatening all these pieces, black doesn't have enough squares for the pieces.
Yeah, white is definitely low on squares here. Looking good for the Greek player. Let's see how this happened. So it was, oh, knight c6 there. That's just a move you don't see every day. Okay,
But knight
d5.
e2 you don't see every day too.
That's true as well. It's the idea is probably to play g3, right? And
Or maybe
after knight.
f3 g4, I don't know.
Yeah, maybe some or f3 g4. Yeah. Yeah, so that the bishop can move to g2 at some point, perhaps, yeah. Or that you can move the f pawn still. But okay, knight c6 played. I don't think that's the main move. Usually they play bishop e7, but okay. Knight c6, d5, knight e7, h4. I would have loved to see h4, but okay, f3, h6, queen d2. Yeah, black is very, very cramped. And after g3, the knights are a bit. Yeah, not the best placed pieces, and especially there you go, finally. Takes, takes, a6, long castle, f4. Yeah, white is just having a nice space advantage, I believe. And taking is probably what makes the position a lot worse for black, because with the pawn on e5, at least black still had some sort of control in the center, while after g takes. White has total control of the center, and now e5 is probably going to be one of the next moves here. Yeah, looking very good for white. Rook g8
What
played,
about
e5.
yes, rook e1? Oh, Kindy.
Ooh.
But it's not a good move comparing to the previous game. Now King D8 doesn't actually make any progress for black.
No. Yeah, the problem was that if black played long castle, that you have queen a7, but king d8 also doesn't look very sharp, although probably it had to be played because of this rook. Yeah,
But
looking
if
very,
you
very
have to play
good.
King D8 in this position, that indicates that something went wrong.
The pieces also look very, very comfortable on their own houses. Yeah, like who needs the center? Who needs more squares than on the fifth rank, the fourth rank? Who cares? We just are going to be chilling on our seventh and eighth rank, and we are going to be very happy. Probably not. I,
Ron,
yeah.
oh, what about game four?
Yeah, let's take a look at the next game. Yeah. Right, knight queen g3. What is happening here? So this is board two of the women's.
This is complicated. White sacrificed a pawn. White was trying to go for some attack. But how to proceed with the attack? The knight on d3 is very strong. If there was no knight on d3, there was a plan of playing knight e2, knight f4, attacking the h5
Oh, knight d2, knight f4. Yeah.
pawn. Oh, yeah, you have too many knights.
I had the wrong knight idea in mind. Yeah,
Yes,
this one's
but
a
with the
better.
knight on d3, it's more difficult to do that. And the pawn on b2 is hanging. So another idea is maybe to go with your plan, knight d2 and knight e4, or knight e4 directly with knight f6 idea. What about that?
Yeah, unfortunately it's black to move, but yeah, 94 looks like an interesting idea with 96 in mind. So yeah, that's why bishop c6
No!
makes a lot of sense here to stop knight e4 ideas. Yeah, this is just looking very, very good for black, I would say. Maybe white can make things a little bit more difficult with g6. What do you think?
G6 makes sense, while it's also opening the file. I'm a bit unsure what to do after G6 rook f8.
Yeah, that's a good
How to.
suggestion. I was thinking maybe we can make use of the g5 square, but yeah. You also, with g6, you're also more or less forsaking the knight of six idea. So yeah, I like rook f8. That's a good counter for his g6 move. Yeah. All right, so black doing well here as well. So that means that so far I think that Greece is doing very well. So let's move on to the next one. Maybe we can
Let's
find a
check
good board.
the last board or the last two boards. This is just more or less equal end game, but I prefer black because of the bishop versus knight in the open position. Not so much, but just slightly better.
Yeah, I agree. The c2 pawn can also become a little bit of a weakness because of this bishop on g6. Yeah. So yeah, I agree, slightly better for white.
We
Yeah.
have the result.
Oh, that's a
The
board one result.
board one was not.
White
It's a
one.
mouse slip. Oh, black
Ay,
wants
ay, ay, ay,
to
ay,
go
that
for queen
hurts.
h4. Unfortunately for Viktor Bologan,
Yeah,
yes.
that's definitely a mouse slip. That hurts so much.
Sometimes these things happen
Yeah.
during online games. Queen h4 was an intention.
Yeah.
But after queen h4, black didn't have easy times. Yeah, we spoke about g3. We could also check bishop f5 immediately, followed by g3 idea. But black has some tricks here. It's not like
Yeah,
completely
something
lost.
with the knight, for example. Yeah, it's not so easy, but indeed black was on the verge of not losing, but it was a di very difficult position for black. Yeah.
Yeah, for example, let's just explain our viewers which ideas they may use. For example, what about knight f8? If a white plays g3 now, we can take the bishop, queen f5, and g6. So
Queen
the
has to
queen
go.
is not trapped. Yeah, and if the queen moves from f5, we take the pawn on h3.
Yeah, so white has to take, g takes, and we've got lovely pawns on the f file, but White has got lovely pawns on the h file as well.
And we are pawn up. Don't forget about that.
Yeah, black is a pawn up. So this is a very messy position. Not sure who's better. But yeah, of course, everything. Actually, instead of bishop f5, I think we started talking about g3 first.
Queen
h3. Takes bishop f5, trapping the queen. And then after rook e2,
black. More or less the only move.
Yeah, rook e2.
Maybe not more or less, maybe just the only move. Yeah, and now we were speaking about queen e8.
Yeah, still looking very, very good for white. So yeah, black would have had a lot of trouble in any case. So maybe that's some sort of consolation. But of course, queen takes h3. Yeah, terrible mouselet. It happens to the best of us, we can now say wholeheartedly. So.
And okay. One more result on board three. Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
We saw this game.
This one we expected.
Yeah, this one we expected. This was the chilling on the back rank or on the seventh rank pieces here from black. And white managed to break through. There's nothing black can do about knight takes d6, I think. So very good game.
2-0 for Greece.
Yeah, seems like it. And all the other games are looking pretty good as well. Let me actually, I think we haven't covered one or two games yet. So this is board 3, 4, 5, 6, this one. And this is the last board of the Greece versus Romania match. This is the one that we haven't covered yet. And this is a interesting position where black is trying to mate on the king side, but white's got some initiative on the queen side. Would you pick black or white here?
Maybe black, because I don't like that white already pushed c5. But maybe it's still okay. Maybe black is just slightly better.
Maybe just.
But I prefer to keep the queens on the board.
With black, you mean, yeah?
With black, yes.
Yeah, so queen h3 is met by queen f1. Queen g4 is an okay move. What?
Queen g4, yeah.
Yeah, queen g4. Well, the bishop is nicely eyeing the f8 square, so moves like rook f8 to try and get the f2 square is not really possible. But h5, h4, I think you've shown this idea in another game as well, in one of the previous broadcasts, I think. Yeah, the h5, h4, some idea to try and create some weaknesses on the king side.
Yeah, awesome. Okay, many ideas for black. I don't know. But for white... I don't think they have so many ideas.
Yeah, for white is a lot more difficult. Yeah, I'm not sure what to play either. I think white needs to maybe start pushing this pawn somehow, but then it means you first have to play rook ab1. Otherwise, well, do you? Okay, I'm going to try something. I'm going to play d5 here.
And just you want fun. To ask me whether I'll take the rook on a1 or not?
Will I take the rook or not?
Big question. Let me think. I'll first take the e3 pawn.
All right, yes. I'll take back.
And okay, let's try to take this rook on a1. Why not?
All right, let's go. I'll take back.
Take back. And oh, yes. Oh, yes. And queen d4 is coming. Maybe it was not a good idea. Yes.
Well,
these bishops, please be careful with them. If you give your... bishop, which is standing next to your king, then your king will feel much more exposed. Be careful.
Yeah,
with that.
Thank you for indulging me there. You don't have to take, obviously, and then this bishop on g7 is going to be a beast. So you could play something like queen f3 or rook f8, maybe even because the bishop is not yet eyeing that f8 square. Maybe that works.
Okay. Rook f8. Maybe a good idea if c takes b6, I have time to play even c takes b6 or rook f3 also. So.
Well, I could take here now, couldn't I?
Take on g7.
Maybe it's not the best move to play rook f8 there. A bit too ambitious, perhaps, because this position looks pretty much okay for white. I think rook d4 coming, rook e1, d6. Like this, should be pretty good. All right, let's take a look what happened. Queen g4 played and rook c2. Yeah, still a very tough position. Everything can still be decided here. Okay, one question that maybe we should answer is like that f3 and queen h3. If the queen g2 mate idea is met by queen f1. And yeah, white therefore doesn't have a lot of difficulties answering that. Okay, that was the last game of this match. We do have another match that was pretty important, I think, for this. Or was I mistaken? Maybe not. Yeah, maybe this is the most important. In that case, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna try and find some interesting games at the very least. So let's talk about.
Romania versus Austria. Okay, Romania is leading at the moment, and Austria doesn't have so many points. But what's going on in that match?
All right, Austria versus Romania. Let me see if I can find some of those games. Nope. Nope.
Almost. One more try. No.
Nope. Let's see. Slovakia, Thailand. Let's see if it's here. Okay, here we go.
Here we
Let's
go.
see.
It is.
So this is Corina Pepton versus Veronica Exler. My guess is that this would be a, well, actually, yeah, that this would be the last board, or this would be the women's board.
This is
Well,
the
let's
women's board.
right. So yeah, white's looking brilliantly here, I believe. Just bishop f5 at some point, just try to get the queen in, and it should be more or less over.
So it's good position actually for Austria, for
Yep.
the underdog team.
And we have a result, I think, in that team is in that match as well. No, this is
No.
Israel versus Singapore, but this is something that's interesting to show. White played knight h5, knight h bishop takes, and queen a5, and suddenly
Nice.
you lose material like this. Yeah, very tough for the white player. So this is a win for the Israeli FIDE Master. There you go. Yeah, tricks like this are sometimes hard to remember, you know. Right, let's move on.
Advance. Maybe the next board after that one?
Okay.
No, it's from another match. Yeah,
Okay,
another
maybe.
direction. Yeah.
Yeah,
No.
I know. Let's see. Here.
Still.
Maybe. Okay, I'm going to try and find back to the. Oh, we've got one here. Yeah.
Romania, yes, one more. Here
Yeah.
it is.
This is probably. Is this the last board or is this the second board? I'm not 100% sure.
I think it's the second board.
All right. Well, there you go. Yeah, let's
I'll
talk a
let
little bit
you.
about this position then. Austria versus Romania.
No, actually, it's board number five. So it's junior board for Romania. Grandmaster Dag Bogdan Daniel playing on the junior board right now, as far as I understand the situation.
All right. Yeah, and of course, everybody, we are going to update the results as soon as we got them, of course. Keep an eye out on the left side of you, where you can see the current results. They haven't been updated yet, but they will, of course, be so shortly. So, yeah, keep an eye out on that. And in the meantime, let's talk about a little bit about this position. It's a very complicated position, yeah, where there's still a lot of interesting tries. What I like for white is that white has got the knights on b3 and c4, and they are nicely eyeing the a5 and c5 weakness like this. While the knights of black are a bit stuck in the center. They don't really have a good place to go to. Yeah, my guess would be that white's very good here.
White definitely has some advantage. The question is, the only question is how big it is. White will develop the dark squared bishop to d2 to connect the rooks, and then they'll decide if they want to try to push f5. Maybe some plan like rook f1 and f5, maybe even sometimes f5 immediately.
Yeah, that's okay,
Thank
never mind.
you. Thank you.
Felix, of course, knew that that was the most dangerous idea. So he wanted to show everybody that that is not possible anymore. So yeah, I like this move, but it's also giving a weakness on g6. So maybe white can somehow try to profit from that. So yeah.
Maybe playing something like e5, e6, but that closes the position a bit too much.
Mm-hmm.
But we can speak about e5. Oh, e5 was played. We shouldn't speak about it. It was just played queen g2. Yes.
You're not really guessing correctly at the moment. But it's all right.
e6 ideas or knight d6. Yeah.
Yeah, I don't like e5 either. I mean, the queen is very nicely positioned on g2. But on the other hand, yeah, this bishop is now forever stuck. It's always going to be looking at the f4 pawn. But okay, on the other hand, this bishop is also forever stuck because it's looking at this nice blockade on e5 here. So yeah, I'm trying to figure out who's, really knight d2.
Knight d2. I thought about knight xa5, in fact, not knight d2.
Well, let's take a look.
Maybe it didn't work, but I had some idea like knight a5, rook a5, queen a5, queen b7. Maybe there is some b3.
Or just, yeah, b3.
Queen a8 and a5. I didn't like it. But b3, yeah. Queen takes b3.
Mm.
With a check. Check, please. Check.
Yeah, with check.
No, but
oh, queen b3 with check. I'm sorry, I didn't see that. Yeah, yeah, that's
maybe
true.
It's not queen. So clear, but yeah. Knight a5 was the move that, you know.
Yeah, it looks very interesting.
Attracted my eye.
Yeah, very complicated this for black. Let's see. So queen d8 then probably has to be played.
a5.
Go. This is looking very, very good. Yeah, a pawns are very hard to stop, especially with the knight. So, okay, let's move on because they are closing in on the time trouble. So I'm curious to see what happened in the game. Okay, this hurts.
White preferred to win in a less complicated way.
Yeah, let's just win the exchange or do some in-between moves and now win the exchange. So, okay. Yeah, the rerouting of the knight did help white there, but black, yeah, just lost an exchange for nothing. And now white can simply consolidate, maybe king h1 or g1. This looks more or less over. All right, so let's see if I can try to find something a little more interesting. So this is the...
Maybe it's... This
no,
this one is from another match.
Yeah, here we've got, I think, the female board, board 6 in this match. So that is Romania versus Austria. We're still looking at that match.
This just looks like exchange down for white.
Yeah, simply looks winning. Idea could be queen c6, rook b1, rook b6, though. Okay. I'm not too sure what's the idea of rook b6, but...
Don't ask
me. Oh, but queen c6? Ah, okay, but you cannot... Well, wait a second. So the king goes here, then rook b1.
No, they are... But because
but
the
bishop
other...
here, and then queen c4, and then it should be over, right? Queen c4, winning the bishop.
Alex,
let's go.
Winning.
Winning. All right, let's move on to the next one. Let's see. Yeah, so I think every game in this match has already finished. Let's take a look at another match. So let's go back to the big match actually in this whole pool, in this round. So that's Greece versus Moldova. And this seems to be the youth board, if I'm not mistaken. And looking good for black, but is it actually winning? That's the question. Seems like it, yeah.
Should be a draw.
Maybe, but how? I guess that white wants to promote, obviously, and if black tries to catch it with the knight, then white can try to catch this one, and then will be a king versus an h1 idea, perhaps. Perhaps that's something that white should go for, but it's very hard to stop both of the pawns if they start running, and the king is also very close to defend this pawn over here, so my guess would... Okay, but that's the wrong way.
Start with c6. Yes, now please don't blunder with c7 because knight d5 fork.
Yeah.
Something like king c4 or even king
Knight
c5.
e6.
Now I
Knight
should bring
c4.
the knight quickly. Try to
Knight
bring four.
c5. Knight c7. Oh, yeah. Okay. Now simply h4, h3, h2, h1. Looks very nice.
A king d5, I believe it's the move in the wrong direction.
Oh, this is nice. This is nice. You cannot take it.
Takes c7, knight g6, and king d6.
Yeah, and c8 queen is
Ah, even
actually.
like this, yeah.
So,
I thought king
yeah.
d6.
Yeah, my guess would have been actually knight d7, but then it's also c8 and then queen. So, okay, but let's move on. Knight f8 played. Black should not take that one. Instead, knight c7, king d6. Knight b5, and I'm guessing that the pawn will be pushed in the next move
Maybe even
or
knight,
for
yeah, knight
nice.
e7 first, and then push the pawn later on. C7, h3, king b6, knight c8, and knight e7. Oh, knight e7. Knight will be perfectly placed on e7.
Yeah,
That's
and
perfect.
actually, I've got brilliant news, something that I can't wait to announce in Pool C. The Netherlands managed to win their match. So there
Wow,
you go.
cool.
Woohoo! Very happy with that, of course. I'm Dutch. I'm supporting my Dutch buddies. So yeah, they won 5.5 against Jordan. So too bad for Jordan, but the Netherlands are doing very, very well. I'm happy about that. All right, and this game is
Yeah,
over. So let's move on. Sorry.
the Netherlands had difficult times yesterday. They drew some of the matches. They drew the first two matches and then they won the last one. But according to the rating, they are the favorites in the pool.
Okay, I'm getting some news. Okay,
So,
in any case, let's see. Well, this position looks already over. There are four positions, four games still being played, so the results are dropping in, as you can see on the left. So Latvia has already won the match. Greece is going strong against Moldova with 3-0. Romania also almost finished. And okay, yeah, the results are dropping in. We'll keep you updated, of course. And yeah, so this is one of the last games that's still going on. This
and
looks
I think we
over.
are having a break and we are leaving and bringing you back one more surprise, one more surprise, and one more interview. Not yet, not yet, but
Not yet. No, our
later.
producer answer does net and net, that's Dutch for just yet. And we are not going to go on a break, so everybody should be really happy because you've got more time with us. And but on this, at the same time, actually, almost all the games are finished. This is the last game going on, and what a brilliant position this is, isn't it? This is one of my favorite end games to watch.
Oh yes.
You never
Oh,
know.
let's speak about it. Yesterday we saw that white actually didn't manage to hold with the rook. Let's see if white will manage to hold it today. No, it's a draw. Wow.
Yeah,
Very
this is
quickly.
already a draw. But yeah, these end games like these are always being played on until the last moment, until the last minute. Because yeah, you never know, there might be a fork with a knight somehow. And especially in with online chess, there might be some tricks or some mouse slips somewhere. So these end games are always being played on, especially in Title Tuesdays as well. So yeah, I mean, this is, let's take a look at how this position occurred, because maybe Black had some winning chances before. It seems like it. So Black was 2 pawns up, but after knight g5, somehow Black lost the other pawn, it seems. Yeah.
Maybe
Okay,
Black
so
shouldn't have allowed that.
yeah, let's take a look. Maybe Black could have played something else here. Not too sure, actually. So this was the position, rook e4 played. Knight of seven, king h5, knight g5. Is there a way that we can maybe save one of the extra pawns? Ah, I've got an idea. What about rook takes here? Knight e6 played. And
And
now
then
maybe
h4.
something like rook h4. Rook takes, king
And you,
g4.
and then
Rook.
bring the rook to h6.
Beautiful square on h6. I'm not sure if this works, but at least it saves the pawn for now. Yeah, this could maybe could have been a way to keep the pawn, and with an extra pawn, this should be winning for black, I believe, yeah.
And then knight h5 and f4. For example, king e5. Were you going to play that, or you had some other idea in mind?
No, king e5, yeah, but
Knight
then yeah,
h5.
knight h5, rook g8. Getting the
F4.
rook off of h6 is going to be a problem here, I believe.
But where
All
is the
right,
pawn going?
guys. Yeah, sorry to do this, but we will have to leave you for a few seconds, everybody. I know you're gonna miss us for these few seconds, but we will be back shortly. So don't go anywhere. We will be back with another surprise guest. So stay tuned for another visitor.
See you in a few minutes.
And welcome back, everybody. And here we are here with a special guest, Mr. Andrei Obochuk. Welcome to the broadcast. How are you feeling so far about the tournament? And oh, actually, I should mention this first. I'm sorry. His English is not so very good. So we have Anna here to translate everything into Russian. And then she will translate everything for us so that everybody can know what we are saying. So yeah, my question is, how are you feeling about the tournament? And of course, welcome to the broadcast.
Здравствуйте, Андрей. Добро пожаловать на эфир. Как вы себя чувствуете? Как ваши впечатления от игры? Как ваши партии закончились?
Я сегодня сыграл 3 партии. 2 партии закончились в ничью, одну я выиграл. Ну, мне очень понравилось. Я, конечно, очень устал.
Andre says that he had played 3 games, 2 ended in a draw and 1 ended with a win for Andre, so he's happy to participate in this tournament, but he already feels a bit tired right now.
Yeah, it's a long tournament anyhow. So tell us about the IPCA, which stands for Internationally Physically Disabled Chess Association.
Yes,
how did that come to existence? And yeah, how do you feel about participating with your team in the Olympia?
Да, вопрос такой. Расскажите, пожалуйста, несколько слов о вашей федерации, как она была создана и вообще впечатление, нравится ли вам играть в этом турнире?
Ну, начну со второго вопроса. Мне, конечно, очень понравилось. Я с большим удовольствием сыграл, тем более, что мы вышли во второй дивизион. Ну, для нас это достаточно большой успех для нашей команды. А наша федерация была основана чешским инвалидом. Его зовут Иржи, я, к сожалению, забыл его фамилию, его уже нет в живых. Вот. А потом, когда он ушел, то его место заступили польские инвалиды, уже очень немолодые люди, а Тадеуш и Богдан Белучики.
Извините, я переведу первую часть, а потом продолжите. IPCA Federation is really glad to take part in this tournament. The Federation was created by a chess enthusiast, Yurji, and he is not alive anymore, but now it's the idea was supported by Polish chess players, and they are running the Federation right at the moment.
Belucik, Tadeusz and Bogdan Belucik, they were very difficult, disabled, and died many, many years ago. And, простите, и потом на место этих людей заступил еще один наш польский друг и коллега. Вот, он мой хороший товарищ. Вот, он сейчас у нас почетный президент. Збышек его зовут, Збигнев, пан Збигнев. Вот. Но сейчас он почетный президент, а нашим действующим президентом является Светлана Герасимова из России, а вице-президент шахматист из Израиля Андрей Гурбанов.
Светлана Герасимова is the head of the federation now. The vice president is Mr. Gurbanov from Israel, while there is Mr. Zbigniew from Poland, who is also doing a lot of work in the federation. So, as you may see, I'll just ask how many members are in the federation. Сколько участников вашей федерации сейчас?
Я думаю, что это представители примерно 20 стран.
Andre says that now the representatives of nearly 20 countries are actually the members of the federation.
All right. Well, it's a pleasure to have you here on the broadcast and explain a little bit more about IPCA. So, yeah, I want to thank you very much for coming on the broadcast. And of course, very good luck in the next few rounds with your team. All the best.
Спасибо.
Спасибо за то, что вы присоединились к эфиру. Удачи вам и вашей команде на следующих.
Спасибо, удачи вам.
And we are back, everybody. That was a really welcome surprise. The team captain and a player of the ICPA. Lovely to have him on the broadcast to tell a little bit about his team. We are not finished with this part of with the rounds yet, because what we owe you still is, of course, the results and the standings. So without further ado, here are the results, the final results of actually Pool C. So I'm very happy to see that the Netherlands won their match once again with 5.5-5 against Jordan. Spain, Italy, a big match actually in that pool with 4.5-1.5. Estonia, Slovenia, 4-2 for Slovenia. Portugal, 3.5-5, winning their match against North Macedonia. Two games still have to be added, but it's clear that Portugal won the match there. Switzerland winning also against Albania. And then, of course, we also have the results from Pool B, round six. They are done for today. Greece winning 5-1 against Moldova, a big clash there. And they managed to get ahead of Moldova. IPCA winning, losing 1.5-4.5, unfortunately, against Latvia. Singapore, Israel, 3-3 tie. Romania, Austria, 4-2 win for Romania. And Slovakia winning 4.5-1.5 against Thailand. And the standings, the thing that everybody has been waiting for. Pool B, Romania, first place, 11 points. Greece, second place, 10 points. Winning the clutch match against Moldova, who are now on fifth place. I can't count. It's actually sixth place. There you go. Slovakia, 9 points on place three. But everything is still open. I think that Romania and Greece are more or less qualified. There should be something really wrong. There should be going something really wrong in the last three rounds, which they will have tomorrow, obviously. And yeah, that was it for Pool B. We will be back after a short break with Pool C, my favorite pool. Let's see how the Netherlands are doing, of course. And yeah, we will be back in a few minutes.
Yeah, the Netherlands, I would like to say they are doing great. After yesterday's two first tough matches, two first tough draws, they won today two matches with crushing scores, 5.5-5 to a half point and 5-1. And they improved a lot in the standings. Right now they're on place two after Spain. And yeah, let's root for the Netherlands right after the short break. We will be back very soon.
Let's do it. And welcome back, everybody, for another coverage of 2020 Online Olympiad. I'm still Roland, and I'm still here with Anna Mzyciuk. Yeah, we have still a long day of games to go, of course, but we're having fun, right, Anna?
Yeah, sure. I am still Anna. Hello, everyone. Yes, I enjoy commentating with you. And let's go with Pool C and with the team of Netherlands.
Yeah, well, not only the team of the Netherlands, of course, it's the one I'm rooting for. But yeah, we're, of course, also have nine other teams in this pool. So here you go, the standings of Pool C so far. We're going to focus on this pool, at least in this round. And you can see that Spain is currently in the lead, winning all matches except for one draw, and the Netherlands following with two matches were drawn, unfortunately, and one big surprise, Anish Giri is not playing, and they're doing suddenly very well. That's a funny thing to mention.
So all you need is taking Anish out, and then things go well for the Netherlands. Yeah. Well, it's just a joke.
Of course, Anish would strengthen any team in this whole, in every division. So, of course, he was having a bad day yesterday. But yeah, of course, he will be back for the Netherlands if they qualify. Okay, but of course, Switzerland, Italy, also doing still kind pretty well. There, nothing is decided yet. Albania, North Macedonia, a lot of countries are still being in the run for qualification. And we've got here some matches for you. Albania, Spain, North Macedonia, Switzerland, Netherlands, Portugal, Slovenia, Jordan, and Italy, Estonia. It looks like these matches are more or less the top of the standings versus the bottom of the standings, right?
Yes, I'm trying to update the results and to get the pairings. Maybe you already got them. Okay, so here we are. That's easier to do it. So yeah. Spain, Albania, North Macedonia versus Switzerland, Netherlands, Portugal, Slovenia, Jordan, Italy, Estonia. Chat, whom are you rooting for? Just leave your comments and the games you would like to see, you would like us to cover. We will try to actually cover all the games as much as we can.
Yeah, send us your requests and yeah, you'll never know. We might cover your team, your board. We've already indulged in some of the requests. So really, we're not just saying that. Really, send us your requests and we will try to oblige with your requests. So the games have started. Before we get into the games, let's have a quick look at what the teams are in Division 2. So let's take a look at some of the countries. You can see them actually, I think these are in average rating order from the left to the right, from the top to the bottom. So we've got Germany, Romania, the Netherlands, Turkey, and Greece as the favorite teams in the Division 2. And as you can see, a lot of other countries are still participating. So there you go, some insight for you. Right. Let's focus on the game. And of course, I couldn't help. We started with a Dutch game. Jordan van Vrees being now the number one board player since Anish has been substituted by Benjamin Bok. Knight c3 being played. This, I haven't seen this opening before, I think. Maybe we should check that.
Unusual opening, not the main line. How is it called? Kali?
I think it's the Cola system, yeah, where you play with e3 and without the bishop to f4, and you try to play with b3 and bishop b2.
I am not sure. Maybe. I am not familiar with the line.
Chat, maybe you can inform us. The idea is very solid. I think that Carlsen even played this opening at some point with bishop b2. Yeah, actually, what opening did Carlsen not play? Right, he's played all sorts of openings already, but okay, it does show that it's a legitimate opening, c4. And white is going to get so-called hanging pawns. How do you play with hanging pawns, Anna? And how is it best to deal with them, in this case, from the black side?
How to play with hanging pawns? With hanging pawns, you should play actively. So especially when the bishop is still on f8, you should think about some moves like d5. Yeah, the blast in the center, because this may sometimes be even winning very quickly. With black pieces, you try to trade the minor pieces and then basically go for an end game, because then it's easier to attack these pawns. So this is like the
That
general.
is more or less what I also knew about this. Yeah. So one of the big in this position, like Anna said, one of the big differences is that the king of black is still in the center, and so blasting open the position with d5 because the bishop is not yet out of black. The bishop is still on f8. Let me click on the right square there. Yeah. I mean, you have a good chance to win if you play very actively at this very moment. If you play it too slow, then black might consolidate. I think interesting moves are, for example, bishop b4, maybe bring the knight over here at some point, or maybe just knight a5, rook c8, trying to undermine the pawn on c4. This is why we call them hanging pawns, because of the pawns on e6 and on b6, the pawns don't really have a move just yet. They have, if the d5 is a good suggestion, but usually moves like d5 and c5 aren't really possible, and that's why we call them hanging pawns. Yeah, it's a very interesting strategic position, at least. We've got a few moves. Black played bishop b4, bishop b2, and now short castle, rook c1, rook c8. So no d5 for white. That makes me a little bit worried about the white position, because, like you said, white needed to be fast. But instead, white played very slowly with moves like rook c1. What's your personal preference? Which color would you take here?
From my practice, I used to play more often against the hanging pawns. While if we speak about the isolated pawn, which is back to actually by the ideas, very similar strategy. I mean, the side who is playing with isolated pawns should also try to play actively, and the side who is playing versus the isolated pawn should try to play strategically and once again, also going for an end game. And speaking about the isolated pawn, I used to play many games on both sides, I would say.
Yeah, you can compare the isolated pawn very much with the hanging pawns. Yeah, I think that more or less the play is the same. Okay, so white is trying something active here with queen a4. Maybe some tricks in the position, maybe something with knight e5 at some point.
Or rook
But yeah.
d1 and d5, another idea.
Yeah, rook d1, d5 looks also very good. So yeah, it's just a very interesting position. Let's see if how they progress, but let's first move on to other boards because a lot of games have already started. So let's see. Here we go. Whoa. Board two, Benjamin Bok versus Ruben Pereira. Benjamin Bok, the substitute for Anish Giri. Black's a pawn up, but white is more or less attacking. Okay, let's check the
There was a
opening real quick.
sacrifice with this f5 move. Let's pay
Yeah.
attention to that.
So short castle, f5. What's this called again? I thought it was called the Grand Prix opening, if I'm not mistaken. Where you go with queen e1, queen h4, bishop h6. You try to attack the black king in this way, but I think it's called the Grand Prix attack. Is that correct?
Yeah, it's some closer to the line, and maybe this exact line is actually Grand Prix attack. But f5, you may play f5 only when it's leading to some, mating combination, because if not, black simply just takes the pawn for free. So let's see if it was a good choice to play f5 immediately or not.
Yeah, the idea of f5 is to put the bishop on h6, but like you said, if you don't get anything in return, then you're just a pawn down. So queen h4, f6. I like this move because after bishop h6, knight g5 is usually an idea. But now that's absolutely not possible because the pawn is protecting it. But still, after bishop h6, I don't know what this position is. I don't know what white's next move would be, because if you take on f5, black can just take back with the knight. So I'm saying that this pawn sacrifice is not good, but I also believe that this pawn sacrifice has a lot of theory in this, if I'm not mistaken. So, but yeah, I don't know. What's your general feeling about this?
I'm not so sure this is like a theoretical position, but speaking about white's threat, I think white is threatening to play queen g3, attacking the bishop on g7, and in case black goes knight g6 to cover this file, then e takes f5 is coming. We will show you the line. Yeah, there's some random move. And
Yep.
yeah, black can't take back on f5 because of the pin over this diagonal. Exactly. So
Yeah.
queen g3 is the threat. In case black plays queen e8, the problem is
Suggestion.
that now d6 pawn is unprotected. So some knight b5 ideas, or bishop takes g7, queen g3, and queen d6 once again. So I don't like queen e8 because of this reason.
Yep. The idea was very good, I believe, because you can try and get the queen in front of your king, which is would be a good defender, but tactically it doesn't work. So what about a simple move? I'm gonna try and play this very dull with King H8.
King h8 is a cool move. Maybe you could also start with playing knight g6.
Well, I
Or
wanted to play knight. Oh, you can play knight g6 immediately. I didn't even see that. Yeah, this is the best move by far. And yeah, you want to play knight g6. And because the queen has to go probably to h5, you can take on e4 now, no problem, right? Or f4, closing down a position. Maybe that's a better idea.
F4, knight e2. I'm a bit worried about this pawn, but maybe it's okay.
Maybe it's okay. Well, even if you lose the pawn, it's still equal material, so maybe it's okay, but maybe f takes e4 is the more ambitious way of playing.
Yeah, let's not give any pawns. Let's play very concrete. In case of knight e4, we have d5. That's why d takes e4 should be played, but after d takes e4, okay, black is a pawn up. Now something simple like queen e7, followed by knight e5. I like this position for black, to be honest.
Yeah, especially because of the not red, the green knight on e5, which yeah, which is just a very good good knight there. Yeah, this is why white is going to have a hard time breaking through the black position. So yeah, I don't know. Maybe this is why, yeah, this f5 pawn break doesn't really work. Maybe it's just not working at all. So knight g6 on the board, queen h3 played though. Does that make a big difference? Yes, because if you take here, bishop takes e6 as a move here. This might be a good suggestion, yeah. But we might be able to solve that by simply playing bishop takes, queen takes, and now f takes e4, because then bishop takes e6 is not possible anymore. And the queen, it's not doing that much on h6 because knight g5 is covered. And the only, yeah, I mean, and knight e5 is still a good idea here at some point. So,
So,
all right.
summing everything up, we still prefer black.
Yeah, we still prefer black in any case. All right, let's move on to the next one. We've been stuck here for a while. Okay, Zakuin Peng. I'm not mistake. I'm probably mistaken, but she has been Dutch national champion for so many times already. I think it's
Something like
actually.
11, 12. I lost, you know.
Yeah, something like that. And only in recent times she's been focusing more on coaching and a little less on playing. So yeah, a lot of there are now other Dutch champions who took the crown at some point. But C6 played. I think that Peng is doing really well. Bishop pair, weak knight on c5. The king's in the imposition, of course, and then could
Maybe
there
just
not?
take on c6, go back to d4.
Yeah, I was thinking that too. I was also thinking maybe there is some trick in the position, but I don't think there is. Well, let's say queen c7 or queen, yeah, where what should be queen b7 perhaps to protect c6. How would you
Yeah, something
progress
like
here with white though? Oh, e5
that.
is an idea, by the way. But
Yeah,
yeah.
e5 is the idea, but maybe you can also think, maybe you can also show the tricks you are trying to make work, like knight d6 on the previous move, I believe.
Yeah, that's true. I tried to make it work, but it's just not a good move here because I think knight b7 is very good.
But why don't you take on d6 simply?
I could, but my
Yeah.
idea was bishop takes. Oh, actually, this is way more simple. Yeah,
Yeah,
bishop
the
takes
problem is the
rook
bishop on
f5.
e2 is unprotected.
Yeah.
Otherwise, yeah, knight d6, it's the move you should definitely calculate first,
Yeah.
because this may simply lead to winning the pawn, but not here.
Exactly, yeah. But after taking, I expect that to be on the board, so let's take a look. No, not yet on the board. Actually, Peng, they are taking their time a little bit in the opening. 15 moves played only, but yeah, after taking knight d4. Oh, by the way, I have an idea. What about taking first? Without taking on c6.
Taking first, not bad.
Well, thank you. Does the, I'm not 100% sure if that works.
Was following the chat and I got a confirmation that Miss Pen is actually 14 times Dutch champion. Can you imagine? Can you
14
imagine
times. Oh
that?
my God.
14 times Dutch champion and 3 times Chinese champion.
Oh my
Wow.
God. That's a lot. Yeah, absolute legend of the chess, of the female chess community. Knight takes d6. Looks very good. I think that actually that Peng is trying to calculate that. But no, she actually took knight d4 and just tried to enjoy a stable advantage, I would say. But on the other hand, after queen b7, black does have some pressure here. So let's say queen b7. How would you continue here as white?
Something like rook d1 or b3. Just some moves that are improving the position.
Yeah, maybe you want to try and play something like knight b3 at some point. But yeah, white is
Try, not sure.
definitely a bit better, we could say. Yeah?
Yeah, looks better. Bishop per advantage, better pawn structure. Also, some kind of weaknesses on c6 and d6 because you already saw there are some tactical issues. Because the knight on c5, well, now it's standing very well and it's very active. But there are some ideas connected to the sacrifices and then this knight, yeah, like
Five.
e5 or some sacrifices on d6. When after these sacrifices, the knight will not feel so comfortable on C5.
Yep, it's true. All right, so let's take a look at another game. Oh boy, this looks like fun. Let's see. Josefina Wehrle, wife of Jan Wehrle, grandmaster in the Netherlands, and also, a member of the actually the Chess Federation in the Netherlands. So it's very nice that she's participating. Queen g3 played. She's got nice compensation over the board. Ah, it's black to move actually, so black can actually take on f3 already.
Maybe with a rook even. I know that Josephine is a very active player. She's very good when it comes to some calculations, to some sacrifices. And as we see in this game, she sacrificed an exchange, but now she's taking it back in the very least. But maybe even rook f3 is better. I don't know.
Yeah, I also don't know. This looks at least very comfortable for black. Yeah, if rook takes, queen g2, maybe queen f5 on the next move, but I don't know. I think it's just safer to just take with the knight. King has to go to h1 because if you go to g2, then you've got rook g5 ideas. So king h1. I want to mate somehow, but I don't think I can.
You want to mate, yes. What
Yeah.
about? There was also some rook g5 move in the very beginning. Maybe it's rook g5, queen f4 is the only move. And maybe something here like queen d6, rook h5, rook
Yeah,
h5, yeah.
queen e6, probably just king h1 to protect against everything.
Yeah,
I
maybe
don't
it's not
know.
the best.
Well, queen e6 now, it's probably maybe a repetition of moves.
So rook h5 now, queen
Queen
g3 back. Yes.
g3.
So this is not the best. If queen g7, then white had rook g1.
Yeah, we should be able to solve this. This looks very good for black somehow. I don't know. This is like solving a puzzle, some puzzle that you see somewhere on the internet, you know, and then you get caught in everything.
True.
Solving all the puzzles.
Some knight g6. Oh, well, that looks a bit strange, but maybe it's working.
Yeah, the
The
queen
queen
has
f6,
to go. Oh,
or
queen
queen
f6. That
f6, rook h5, and queen e6. So this
yeah,
guy's
or
good for
queen
queen
c.
c6.
Yeah. Looks like that would not be enough. Okay, well, it's a mystery then. Maybe it's just, let's see what happened in the game, because we could talk about this for a while. Knight takes a free play. King h1. This seems to be the critical position.
Critical position, yeah. You're sad.
Yeah. I feel a bit frustrated. I want to solve this.
Rook h5.
Yeah, but then simply take.
Rook h3.
Take.
A
Or
queen
king
and queen
g2.
c3.
Let's just take. Yeah, take. King g1.
Queen takes c3.
Yeah, that black is two pawns up. Maybe in the end it's gonna be three pawns. This is very hard to defend, at least for white, yeah. This looks pretty good. Okay, so Josefina doing very, very well. That is a warm feeling to my heart. So never mind. Okay, so next game. Whoa, wee. Okay. It's okay. So we've got another substitute. Leon Vrolijk is the substitute of Max Warmerdam in this match. In this, in probably today, Leon Vrolijk, a very huge talent in the Netherlands. Let's see how he's doing.
He's two
Maybe.
pawns up, and I'm afraid, but maybe the best move was King D1. Yeah, because now Black can take on D2 and take on F4, but after King D1, I was keeping everything under the control. I think I was keeping everything. I'm not sure, but maybe I was.
It looks like it, yeah. King d1. I don't see a breakthrough anywhere, so yet.
So now,
Let's
if D
go.
takes F4, we have Bishop F4. Coordination. Nice.
Yes, this is looking very, very good for white. So yeah, but he played queen d2. I'm wondering what he was afraid of. Maybe. I don't know. It doesn't seem like he has to be afraid of anything, but
Maybe
yeah,
he
the
was
king
just
is a bit
afraid.
exposed here. Maybe it was more like a practical decision than anything else, because let's see what
Let's
happens
take a
after
look.
queen
Let's
d2.
take a look at Queen D2. Okay, Queen takes
Yeah.
D2, King D2, G takes F4. The problem is that the E5 pawn is fallen, but okay,
Two pawns
C5
down.
pawn. If Bishop C5, then Rook D8 is the problem. So maybe just to move the knight to C4.
Yeah, and then maybe bishop takes e5 in the next move. There's also another pawn hanging on h5, so maybe it was just a practical decision. Just be a solid pawn up after all the exchanges. Let's say you go back here. Then you can take either pawn and you should be pretty happy here as white, I believe. Because it was just a practical decision, that's all. I know that I played a few times against Leon Vrolijk, and he's a very practical player indeed. So he's just trying what is best for the game and not just what's best in the position. And yeah, it's all about winning, yeah. All
Yeah,
right.
if you win the game, then it doesn't matter how you manage to do that. Well, if it's like a fair way, but yeah, you just choose if you want to play more practical or you want to go for some complications, depending on your style.
Absolutely, yeah. All right, so let's take a look at the last board. Machtot van Vrees playing with black against Camila Avellino. And she's a solid pawn up. That's a joke. She's not a solid pawn up, but
She's not a pawn up at all.
it feels like it though. I mean, the king is very active, and I don't know. These kings are the difference here. But the question is, how do you try and break through as black? Maybe try to c6 like this, but I don't know. Maybe you want to play something like king f5, rook here. I like
Oh.
black though. I think the kings are better. The black king is better. The rook is better. So I'm sure the black has some chances somehow. But it's not so easy to see how black can continue with this game.
The activity is on black side. I would prefer to push the pawns slowly, something like maybe b6, c6, a6, b5. Because the king is placed very well, the rook on d2 is very active, the rook on e3 has to stay there because otherwise it's difficult to defend the pawn. If white goes f4, then king f5 will be unpleasant, so I wouldn't recommend white to, you know, play really
Yeah.
very actively.
It seems.
So yeah.
It seems the white is just stuck in this position. So I'm very happy. All the games that we saw are looking very good for the Netherlands. Yay. Okay, let's
I'm not
move on
so.
to. Yep, I'm sorry.
I think, like, you know, about the last move g3, I thought it was better for white to play a rook g3, attacking the pawn on g7. In case black plays g6, then maybe some idea like rook f3 and threatening rook f6, rook c6, just to find some activity because I don't like to play passively. So, yeah,
Yeah, I think
this
you're
rook will
absolutely
have to go
right.
to d7, then rook e3, and yeah, let's go.
Yeah, maybe now a move like king f5 would be an idea to try and place it like this, because there is now a tempo. The rook is already on d7, so we could try and maybe play something like this.
But you know, even if you win this pawn, isn't it a draw?
Ah,
Because the pawn went.
because of the pawn structure. Yeah, this extra pawn doesn't really matter on the queen side, so. Maybe it's a draw, yeah. But on the other hand, this king is also a bit more active. But yeah, you're right. It could still be a draw there, yeah. Yeah, this is probably the way to play for white. Well, with the passive approach of g3 and now a6, yeah, white's basically not doing anything. Just waiting for black to push the pawns and create something on the queen side. Okay, let's move. Let me see if I've got all the games. I do. Okay,
I was trying to
so
think about the spawn endgame. Maybe actually it's not a draw.
it's always
Because,
hard to judge, yeah. In
yeah.
some positions where you've got an extra pawn, the extra pawn doesn't really matter, but in some it really depends on the king side, I think, on the king position. If black has the better king, then it's probably winning. It's not, then maybe it's a draw, right? All right. But let's move on. We've got a result. We've got Monica Ruiz winning against Eglantina. So that is Spain winning. No, losing. My
Spain
mistake.
losing.
Against,
Actually, Monica Calzeta Ruiz is a grandmaster from Spain. She's a strong player. And it's a surprising loss because she lost to women candidate master Eglantina Shabanai. I don't know this girl or this woman, sorry.
Well, now you know. Now everybody knows of Eglantina Shabanai. So beating Monica Ruiz of Spain. Yeah, the trick is, of course, e takes d6, rook e8 with mate.
But was it like a last move blunder or the position was bad?
Queen d6 played. Ah, black was doing really well here, actually. But after queen g3, threatening
rook
queen
c8.
b8. Rook c8 would have been perfect, no problems whatsoever. Good bishop, pawn up. Yeah, it would have been good, but black played queen d6. Now it's a blunder because of rook e8. Mate, unfortunately for her.
Yes.
Okay, another result over here. Mansur Samir losing against Jure Boyrisek. So. Oh no, wait. Mansur Samir winning against Jure Boyrisek. Yeah, rook g1, c2 next. And we've got over here, we've got another result. Angela Flavia Grimaldi of Italy winning against Linda Maria Pohl from Estonia. So these are the results that I see so far. Yep. All right, let's move on to another match.
Let's move on to some games that are still in progress.
Well, we have still a lot of games in progress. We're very close. We are not even close to the end of it. We've got like 20 games still going on.
Yeah.
Let's take a look at this one. This looks like fun. Oh, this is board one, actually, of the Netherlands. Well, that was not intentional, everybody. It really wasn't, by the way, but it looks very interesting, doesn't it?
Jordan Warren Forrest trying to attack. Not only trying, he's very successful in that.
Looks
Maybe
like
not,
it,
maybe
yeah.
not.
Bishop
Maybe
takes
not, maybe not.
g7 next, but the bishop is attacked. What if we just take everything with f takes e6? Or
maybe
knight
knight
takes b2.
b2 is actually more precise because if f takes e6, bishop g7 was coming, or...
I wanted to take here, but I guess queen c2 is okay, yeah?
Maybe bishop
Or...
f8?
I
As
did not
simple
even
as
think
that.
that
You
move.
taught me to play simple.
Yeah, the hardest thing to do is to play simple. Yeah, nice quote there. Yeah, this looks winning for white. It's just an exchange up, I think, because after queen takes, rook takes, knight is hanging on c4, and white is a full exchange up. So, okay, let's move back. Knight takes b2 looks very good in that case. Queen takes, rook takes, queen takes, f takes. Well, that looks very bad for white, actually.
Maybe not that bad. Rook h4 still with some mating ideas. But black is a pawn up, and black can also create some threats and attack white's king.
Very agreed here, actually.
So queen d5, queen d5, rook h4, king d8, bishop h7. Looks good for white.
Oh, bishop h7, I totally missed that one as well. Now after king f7.
Queen c7.
c7, king f6, rook f4. Yeah, this is mate, actually.
You see, I am trying to do everything possible.
Yeah, you're
You
doing
have a
it.
nice
You're...
position.
Yeah, you're seeing everything today. It's all right, so in that case, queen e5 is probably a blunder. Then we need to protect against rook h4 somehow.
Maybe trying to move the f8 rook.
Yeah, if you do that though, let's say I place the rook on f6. Ah, then after rook h4, king g8, bishop h7, you've got king f7, and then everything is okay.
That was my
Yeah,
plan.
That's a really good suggestion. Let's see if black played it. Let's hope not, of course, but king g8 played, rook, queen c2. Okay, king g8 was also a good move. Prophylactics against everything, queen c2. Queen d5 on the board, check. King h8, bishop e4. I'm not so
d4 check.
sure. Check, king g2, takes, takes, rook
and
f2.
f2.
Okay, yeah, oh, okay. Black is a pawn up, that's why. Black is trying to exchange everything and win in the end game, more or less. But yeah, once again, we've got an interesting rook ending. This is now the current position on the board. I think white has very good chances to keep this to a draw, yeah?
It's not so easy because it's not like a typical rook end game. We see that the pawns are... not on one side. Yeah, this e6 pawn may be the problem. But yeah, I agree with you that white has good chances to save this game, despite being the pawn down.
Yeah, despite being a pawn down. But yeah, black is still, of course, we're also closing in on the time trouble phase, so you never know what happens there. It's of course true that black is in the driver's seat, so white needs to be very careful. Right, let's move on. Let's actually take a look at another match because I feel like I've been a little bit selfish by checking the Dutch team always. So
let's
take
look
a look
the results,
at...
maybe. Because we have many games finished.
Yeah. Some results, we've got a lot of results here. Yeah, so Albania, this is a draw, opposite colored bishops. We've got here a black win for Albania. So actually, is Albania upsetting? Albania might be upsetting against the second team in the standings against Spain. How about that? Let's take a look. Another result.
Albania versus
Spain.
Spain. Just a second. I'll update the score. It's 2-2 at the moment.
2-2 at the moment. This might be an upset, Dania.
Yeah, the first two boards are still playing. So maybe let's take a look at the game Ashiko versus Shiro
Yeah.
and Pasco versus Perez Candelario.
All right, this is Alexei Shirov with the black pieces playing against Frank Ashiko. This actually looks winning for black because the bishop is nicely controlling everything.
Yeah, just bishop
Bishop
f5.
a5, king goes, bishop e4, f5, and it should be over. Black won. Nicely done. So 3-2 for Spain then, yeah. And then we've got one more game.
And second board.
That's already over, it seems. That's this game.
How did
So
Perez Candelario play versus Pascal Lambi?
that's this one. That is a draw. So that
Draw.
means that
Okay.
Spain won the match eventually, 3.5, 2.5 against Albania, I think, yeah.
But it wasn't an easy match for Spain.
No, it was almost an upset from Albania. Albania actually qualifying from the previous division. So if they would have done that, that would have been really amazing for them. All right, let's take a look now at Switzerland against North Macedonia. This is Noel Studer versus Kirill Georgiev. This looks absolutely winning for white. White is a piece up, and this pawn will jump forward. So let me find a little more exciting game that's still going on. This one we just checked, but this is an in I'm not doing this on purpose, everybody. I'm just trying to find interesting positions. And it seems like this is kind of interesting, but on the other hand, it looks like white, black is simply winning. This was actually the queen and rook ending that we actually talked about, right? More or
Yeah,
less.
queen versus two rooks, but now black has a lot of pawns. The king will run out of the checks, and yeah, seems like an easy win for black.
Yeah, queen
Queen
e2,
c5.
d2 should be more or less over. All right, let's see if I can find another interesting game. This one looks pretty interesting.
Oh, this one.
Jordan
Nice pick.
versus Slovenia.
So it's David Stevanic playing versus Malek Saif.
Yeah.
And what's happening? Is it a perpetual check? Black
Seems
is a
to be like
pawn
it.
down, but these bishops
Huh.
are very strong. No, Black decided to continue the game. Maybe the tournament situation forced Black player from Black side to continue the game.
Black is trying to play for a win here. Yeah. Is it justified though? Because, I mean, Black does have the bishop pair, but the king is so far away. Well,
Oh, rook
g1,
g1, rook
probably knight f5 looks winning, yeah.
f5, rook f5, so
Hey,
many.
rook f5 on the board though, also not bad. I
What
wonder why
about?
Black took a chance here and tried to play for a win.
But if black continues with it, no, rook e6 is not possible anymore.
No,
I think.
no, 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 no. How do you say repetition anymore? Rook f8 played, knight f5. Oh, this looks so dangerous. Probably king g. No, rook
Oh
g6, but
no, this
then.
is just under the bishop. We can just
Yep,
take it.
that is. Yeah, that was not a good attempt to play for a win for black, unfortunately. King takes g6, probably just knight e6 or knight f5 looks pretty good. You want to play rook g8, but there's a bishop, unfortunately. So,
Don't do that, please.
yeah.
We had enough of upsets today and also some mouse slips. Knight c6. Threatening knight e5 and knight a7.
Knight c6, a6, knight e5. Yeah, this looks more or less over. And we're actually looking at the final game of this round, it seems. And actually, with that, all the you can see an update on the left side. It's not 100% updated yet, so we'll keep you posted on that, of course. At least we can say one result, and that is that Spain won their match against Albania. So congrats to them.
I have
Yeah.
all the results. In fact, Spain beat Albania 3.5 to 2.5. North Macedonia beat Switzerland 4-2. That's a bit surprising.
Yeah.
Netherlands beat Portugal 4-1 already in one game. It's 5-1 because I believe Josefina Vrla won her game. I believe so. Slovenia beat Jordan 4-1, and this will be 5-1 after the game we have just covered. And Italy beat Estonia 4-2.
All right, those are all the results. We are going to, of course, show those results in a nice card for you on the screen. But for now, let's remind everybody real quickly what is the actual online 2020 Olympiad, the thing that we're broadcasting right now. Let's take a look. We are here at all the divisions, and the divisions, as you see now, we are now in Division 2. All the other divisions before that, the base division, Division 4, Division 3, those were all played in previous weekends where they could qualify for the next division. So in Division 2, the teams can qualify for the top division, and in the top division, it will be decided who will move on to Stage 2. And here you go with Stage 2. What will happen with Stage 2? Well, basically, you can keep in your mind players with big medals on their backs, you know, because you can win medals here for the Olympiad, where, who will be the winners here? That's more or less what's going on. We first start with the preliminary round, then the quarterfinals, of course, then the semifinals, and then the finals. Yeah, so, yeah, that is what they are all playing for, all the teams in Division 2, in the top division on the next weekend, and, yeah. Here we've got some more information for you on the online Olympiad. And yeah, a truly worldwide event, 163 teams, all divided over all these divisions. And they were divided according to strength and are further divided into pools within those divisions based on time zone and strength. You wouldn't want a team to play in the afternoon and another team at night. That would be a big disadvantage for one of the teams. So that's why we did that. And yeah, one of my favorite things here actually is that each team features two open boards, two women's boards, one junior male board, and one junior female board. So yeah, that is wonderful, isn't it, Anna? So yeah, I mean, we had a little bit of a discussion about that. Should this be the normal format, or should teams still consist in later Olympiads, like the separation of the men and the women, for example, or the youth and adults, I would say. That's an interesting discussion to follow, right?
Yes, we can once more refer to the chat. Please drop a comment, say what you think about this format. What would you like to keep? What would you like to change? What you liked, what you disliked? And meanwhile, I see that the standings are already updated. Do you have this template, or should I just proceed with?
No, actually, you are correct. We've got the current standings of Pool C. On the left side of you, we've got Spain with 9 points. We've got the Netherlands with 8 points. We've got Italy with 7 points. We've got Slovenia with 6 points. We've got North Macedonia also with 6 points, and Switzerland also with 6 points. Those countries are doing pretty well in the race for the top three spots, which will give them a qualification seat for the next division, which will be the top division. So one big result, like you mentioned, North Macedonia beating Switzerland. That's a bit of a surprise, isn't it?
Yeah, for me, I mean, not like a big surprise, because these teams were more or less level, but just Switzerland was sharing the top places. And now after losing this match, they are with six points and they don't have good tie breaks. So yeah, looking at the standings, I can say that Spain and Netherlands, they are clearly the favorites, while Italy, it's not so clear. They have 7 points, but there are three teams behind: Slovenia, North Macedonia, and Switzerland with just one match point behind. So it's completely unclear. Let me remind you that the first three teams qualify to the top division, so it's like the big fight.
Yeah, exactly. Keep that in mind, everybody. And of course, we'll keep this is not the last day. Tomorrow we will have, of course, round 7, 8, and 9 for all the pools. So Yeah, there is so much chess going on actually this whole month. We started, I think, at the end of June or at the beginning of August with the base division, and then we started moving on to the fourth division, third division, and so on. And now we are here at the second division. And actually, guys, our producer has been busy, is actually making some nice cards for you to show us. So for example, here we've got a very nice individual standings card where you can see in pool C, Alexei Shirov being having the best results in the pool with 4 out of 4. Actually, let's give not it's actually one of our producers who made this card. Very much thank you, Simon, for making this. This is a lot of fun to look at, and I'm happy to see two of the Dutch players also in the pool C. So Jordan van Vreest and Roze Rasma doing very well there. But yeah, a lot of is there a name that's that catches your eye, who you expected or did not expect there to be?
I don't know. Yeah, I'd just like to congratulate the players who made these nice results. And we also see some players with 5 out of 5. Victoria Radia from Bulgaria with 5 out of 5, as well as Antonios Pavlidis also with 5 out of 5. Great achievement. Congrats to these players. And yeah, of course, Alexei Shirov, as you mentioned, was 4 out of 4. He's playing on the top board, so it's twice as difficult to make an all. That's it. So
Yeah, it's a great card though. I wish we had it's very hard for us to keep track of the individual scores. Yeah, there are a lot of players participating in each pool, in each team, so it's hard for us to keep track. But it's amazing that Simon of chess.com actually made this for us. So yeah, thank you very much for that. And with that, everybody, I think we are good to go on a break. So don't go anywhere. We will be back shortly after a few minutes for, of course, more action in the online Olympiad of 2020. Stretch your legs, grab some popcorn, always good to have, and then we will be back shortly.
I think it will be a short break, after which we will be covering the last game for today in Group C, and then we will move to Group D. So stay tuned, we will be back shortly.
Yes, and we are back, everybody. Welcome for, of course, the continuation of the broadcast on the Olympia 2020. I'm still Roland, and I'm still here with Anna Muzichuk, with my lovely co-host here. We will be presenting, of course. Yeah, we still have got one round to go, I think, for Pool C. And yeah, I'm also excited, of course, to cover Pool D. Are you still excited, Anna? How are you feeling so far?
Sure, of course. It will be the last round in Pool C, as you mentioned. The last round for today, not the last round for the tournament. And Pool D is starting with the first games. So they will start right now. And we will be covering Pool D and later on also Pool D. Everything will be covered. Don't worry.
Everything will be covered. We were here actually since morning. So yeah, if you want to see a lot of chess, we will also be here tomorrow morning, and well, at least in our times, but actually throughout the whole day. So keep an eye on the twitch.tv/chess channel for a lot of chess, because the Olympiad is gonna last for not only this weekend, but also the next one and the next one. So a lot of chess this month that you can enjoy. So yeah, keep that in mind. Okay, let's talk a little bit about the next round, because in Pool C, we've got round 6 going on. We've got Spain versus Estonia, as you can see on the left side, everybody. Jordan versus Italy, Portugal versus Slovenia, Switzerland versus the Netherlands. That might be the big clash in this round. And we've got Albania versus North Macedonia. So far, of course, 0-0. The games have yet to begin. That's what I was looking for. English is hard sometimes, please forgive me. And yeah, looking like interesting matches to me. Let's take a quick look at also Pool D. Round 4 is going to start with Norway versus Guatemala, Ireland versus Denmark, Croatia versus Turkey, Iceland versus Serbia, and Chile versus Sweden. Yeah, but of course, we are going to cover Pool C round 6, and we'll give you, of course, updates on what's happening in that round. Yeah. Anything to add to that?
I think that was perfect. Let's start with the games. I believe they are starting soon, like in the next minutes. So maybe just remind our viewers about the format. Meanwhile, we're often speaking about the format, but we don't say so often that it's rapid games. The time control is 15 minutes plus 5 seconds per move.
We can pull a card up to make that point a bit more clear with the time control and a little more, also some extra information. So here you go. The format and, of course, the highlight, what we're doing is the time control, 15 minutes plus 5 seconds per move. And yeah, the scoring, something that we also don't mention very often, it's a win is 2 points, a draw is 1 point, and a loss is 0 points. Now, there was this scoring where they tried to do a football scoring, which means a win is 3 points and a draw is 1 point and a loss is 0 points. Is that something that you would like to see back, Anna?
I know that this type of scoring is not actually that popular. To be honest, I have played so many tournaments myself and I have never played a tournament when this scoring was used. Can you believe that?
No.
So I don't know what's the feeling, and do you actually change the strategy? Do you try to play more active? Because, I mean, for winning, you get 3 points, which is a lot. I don't know. Or you just keep on, you know, playing normal games and see how it goes. The scoring forces the players to play more active, and they are ambitious to get these 3 points because this makes a very big difference.
Yeah, I think it's kind of funny because also in football leagues, you can see, for example, the scoring, and they always use this. There has never been an issue with that. But I think maybe the difference is that in chess, you can have draws, and that is what makes it a little bit different. But on the other hand, like you said, it does create some more ambition in the team, because of course 3 points is better than 2, and so you can create more distance to your opposing teams in that way. So chat, what do you think about the football scoring, We are using here 2 points for a win, 1 point for a draw, and 0 points for a loss. So tell us your opinions about the scoring system here. And let us know what you think about that. I think that was our one of the dogs actually behind the scenes. It was a little bit tired, but there you go. He's still alive. That's what we wanted to know. So thank you for that, Wouter. Any case, yeah, the games are almost ready to start, everybody.
Yeah, let's go to the games. I think we have clear favorites in these pairings in Pool C. I think Spain has some advantage over Estonia. Maybe not only some, because Spain is actually the leading team, while Estonia is on the 10th place. Jordan, Italy. Italy is the favorite. Portugal, Slovenia. Slovenia is a bit stronger. Netherlands has a bit stronger team than Switzerland. And North Macedonia is a bit stronger than Albania. But okay, it's just by ratings and everything can happen over the board.
Exactly. Yeah. So, yeah, there's still a lot to play for in this pool. And yeah, I'm actually hoping that Jordan will do well. That would be like one of the biggest upset, of course. And they're one of the few Arabic countries still in the lead here. Well, still in not in the lead, but in the race. So, yeah, I would like to see Jordan do well. And I heard that Jordan actually produces very nice foods. For example, I heard that Jordan is like the biggest country of shawarma, and I'm personally a very big fan of the shawarma. Did you know that, or do you like shawarma in general, Anna?
No, I didn't know about that. And yeah, yesterday we were talking about where Jordan is located. To be honest, it's easier to say where Jordan is located than to name some chess players from Jordan, I think.
Yeah,
anything can happen in some games.
By the way, talking about food, have you ever tasted some of the Dutch cuisine?
I have played a couple of times in Holland. Yeah, I did play a Wacken Zee tournament. Once I played in Amsterdam. By the way, I like your country. It's like, you know, everything's so tiny and beautiful, and the roads are quite cute. So yeah, I like your country. I like the hospitality of the organizers and how the tournaments were organized in Holland. So I had a nice experience, and I spent nice time in Holland, and I did try some food, but can't say that I am so familiar with like Dutch cuisine. What is like the national food? What are the names of the dishes? Please tell us a bit about that.
Yeah, well, there's this Dutch streamer. She is called Anna Maya. She's pretty popular nowadays on Twitch. She streams chess, and I can recommend everybody to follow her Twitch channel. She's just usually playing chess, also doing some other games, like for example, marbles and such. But her favorite food is stroopwafels. Yeah, it's like a famous cookie. It's like some cookie with syrup on it, and it's round, and it's a typical Dutch cuisine, yeah. And what else? Well, pancakes. We were very famous for our pancakes and for our stews. I think we got a lot of potato stews or something. But the weird thing about the Netherlands is actually, we're talking about the Netherlands now, but okay, indulge me for a moment, because you'd never see in foreign countries a Dutch restaurant. You never see that. You don't, when you go to New York or to some other country, to Berlin or something, like Germany, of course, you don't see Dutch restaurants. And that is more or less an indicator that the Dutch cuisine is not the best, but still we've got nice things. We've got nice cookies. We've got nice, what else do we have? Pancakes, like I said. So yeah, everybody do visit our country. We've got lovely stuff. Yeah. All right.
Nice. Thank you. Oh. Thank you, Roland, for this inside information. Thanks for providing some additional information from your country, from the cuisine of your country.
I've got some questions about the Ukrainian cuisine as well, by the way. But
Let
we'll do that later, Anna.
it be.
Okay.
Okay.
The games have started. Actually, I want to see the match Jordan Italy, actually, because we've been speaking about the country of Jordan a little bit. Let me find board one. I think this is board one. Daniil Deverney versus Mansour Samir. Mansour Samir upsetting, I think, in the last round. So we can see what he is going to do. What are your first thoughts about the position, Anna?
I think I have some problem because I don't see your screen. So just a second.
Oh.
Yes. If you could continue speaking about the games
Yep,
and
of course.
I will
The games
wait.
are visible, a little technical discrepancy there, but I think we should be able to later. Well, okay, the rook a3. I really like this move. Maybe
Okay.
the rook has a lot of squares to maybe make some use of. Maybe rook b3 at some point. The rook is protected, so you can also move the d pawn if you like. I like this. In general, I like white a bit better. I don't know. It seems like white has a very straightforward plan. That's why, and otherwise, maybe e4 at some point. But black can maybe break through in the center as well. Anna, are you back following the games?
Yeah, sure. I am following. I don't know. It was like something, maybe something was updating on my computer. That's why it was like frozen for a few seconds and I couldn't see the game. But yeah, it was fixed very soon. Knight f6 played on the board, not allowing h5. I agree with you that b5 is like the main plan for black while trying to play in the center with e4, f4. Maybe then bringing the rook. Okay, after queen d3, it's difficult to bring the rook to f3 or e3. But queen d3 is the move to protect against b5 and to support e4 better.
Yeah, I think so too. Rook h1. I'm not sure that white's playing for the right. Well, okay, h5 is a nice threat, actually. I was thinking, let's say black plays rook ab8, then white can play h5. And of course, if you take g takes, queen takes, it's suddenly mate. So this is the game. This is something that white is playing for. But black can maybe simply play a move like h6 to counter that. With the knight not being on g5, h5 is less likely to occur.
I
So
think
I
it's.
like black actually a little bit more. But this is the current position, by the way.
H6 sounds very reasonable, and then we may continue with rook AB8, followed by B5. Yeah, these typical plans which we mentioned. And I also like black's position because black has managed to trade some minor pieces, and this is good for them because they lack some space. Yes, so yeah, when you don't have so much space, it's better that you trace some minor pieces, and black succeeded with that.
Absolutely. I totally agree. And before we move on to the next game, let's show quickly the card of what all the pairings are for this round in pool E, for example. So let's take a look at that at the current card that's right now there. Or, well, never mind. We're not going to do that. So let's take a look at the next game simply. Here
Yeah,
we've
so
got
let's
an
move on. Oh,
interesting
d5.
game.
d5, look at this trick. It takes d5, e4. How do you like it? A lot.
This looks interesting. Well, the idea is e takes and then e4 with a nice double attack there. But I like rook ae1 as well. I don't know. This requires some calculation, I think, there. We
Yes.
could play something like, well, d takes e5 runs into knight takes e5, and e takes d5 runs into e4. So rook ae1, logical move here. If black takes, let me quickly do some calculation. D takes, knight takes, e takes, bishop takes looks good for white. So it's an interesting tension in the center, isn't it? I'm not too sure if either of the players should take somewhere in the center. Looks like maybe just queen d6 is a good move or something.
Well, if you play Queen e6, e takes d5 is possible now,
Yeah,
as
because you
there is
don't
no
have a.
e4 anymore.
But yeah, okay, knight takes, you've got knight c4 ideas, yeah.
Or knight e4. Maybe not queen d6, maybe something else.
Yep, maybe something else. All right. C6, maybe?
C6. Why not?
Yeah, and then maybe white plays rook e2.
Or bishop g5. I'm thinking now to create some pins.
Yeah, bishop g5. It's interesting how the tension is developing in this position. Bishop g5, h6. Takes, or do you want to play bishop h4?
Bishop h4, maybe, but you know, you picked up some complicated position. We need some time to, you know, to realize what's going on and then to come up with the best advice. But yeah, to speak about something from scratch, it's a bit difficult.
I like to have interesting discussions about positions like this, but
we could some keep blunders.
Some blunders are more easy to discuss, but we could in general say that there is some tension in the air, and I think that the one who breaks the tension first will probably be less off in the position, and about the position I guess should be about equal there. All right, so let's take a look at another game. So this looks like a funny position. Marina Brunello playing against Gaida Alatar Gaida from Jordan. What do you think about this g5 break?
I'm not so scared about this g5 break because the king is not on g8, so the king can potentially even castle alone after many moves. But yeah, it's not under the attack. Knight h7, the move you mentioned is that's a good try. Yeah, white can't, but maybe white. No, I can't take on h6. I was trying, you know, to make this trick bishop h4, h takes g7, rook g8, and I thought maybe queen h6 worked, but no, there is bishop g5.
Yeah, unfortunately, exactly
Roland wanted to trick me this way, but no, 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 no.
Very good, very good. Yes, I saw this as well. Yeah, I was hoping this would work, but I don't think it can.
So knight after knight h7, yeah, maybe just f4 and trying to say that knight on h7 is not an active piece. So maybe not knight h7. Maybe it's simply better to take the pawn on h5 and keep a good structure, keep the knight on f6. Just asking white, well, okay, you play g5, but how do you continue the attack?
Well, how's black going to continue? Just a move like knight of fate, perhaps, and bishop d7? Or this bishop needs to be developed somehow, but yeah, I don't know.
Maybe knight of fate is not a bad move. Maybe queen c6, knight b6, or it's too slow?
Queen c6, knight b6, you said. That looks actually like a good idea. That makes that has some potential, yeah.
Queen c6 is also maybe threatening bishop b4, maybe not, but maybe yes.
Yeah, a lot of ideas with this. Yep. So looks good. Yeah, queen c6, a big fan. Let's see how this is going. So g5 played, h takes played, bishop takes played, queen c6 on the board, nice.
Oh, I can I could b6. Guess some moves. Yeah, knight b6, now bishop d7. Oh, knight c4 is coming, and maybe black will castle on, as I promised.
Yep, and with that, the king will be quite safe on the queen side, not with any problems, it seems. All right, let's move on to another game then. See how this game is. Well, this one is one of the most clear positions that we've seen, I think. So I think white's doing very well here. Yeah.
It seems like lots of threats are hanging over black's position. For example, what about taking on g6, following with bishop c4?
Probably king h.
Queen h8, yeah, maybe. Queen h4, knight h5,
knight h5 even, that's even better, yeah.
So maybe we shouldn't release the tension, then let's keep the pawn on f5 and start with bishop c4. What about that?
Yeah, sounds very good. Probably, well, I wanted to play King H8, but I'm not sure that's the best idea of the Queen H4.
Knight H7 or Knight H5, Knight D5, and F6.
He goes somewhere and then F6, and suddenly there's a bishop trapped on D7. So, yep, just Queen Bishop C4 first, threatening to take here. What happens if you take here?
I think I shouldn't take on f5. I think I can do something, yeah, like rook g1, something more useful. Just, yeah, go on.
This g-file is going to be a pain for the Jordan player, unfortunately. So Elena Sedina of Italy doing very well in this position, it seems. Maybe they have already got some moves on the board. Queen
not
b6
yet.
Played, not yet. She is thinking quite long, Elena, but in this position, I think it's more or less already over after bishop c4.
But yeah, Yelena is this kind of the player who actually likes to spend quite a lot of time in the opening and middle game phase, while then when she's in the time trouble, she plays quite okay. So
Okay.
no worries. Let's try to focus on some other games, maybe. Oh, bishop d5.
That works, yeah. I mean, if you take here, then you lose material, queen takes f7, so king h8 probably only move.
King h8, then I expect lots of trades on e5, something like bishop e5.
Rook takes, or rook
ah,
takes.
there is a trick. If rook e5, rook e5, queen e5, trying to go for an endgame, maybe we have rook e1.
Oh.
Cute!
That's a pretty cute one. Haha,
Queen
nuts.
h5, maybe the only defense, but still.
Still, this looks very bad. Queen f3.
Queen f3, bishop g4, maybe. Maybe
Bishop
not queen
g4,
f3.
yeah, that doesn't work.
And maybe
what
this way we will trick
else?
ourselves. But we can
Well,
move the bishop.
you could take here, maybe, actually.
Yeah, that's what I wanted to say, and take on c6.
Yeah, looks good. All right, so yeah, that's a trick to watch out for. So maybe f takes e5 is the better move here.
And then bishop f3. I think white is a bit better because of the pawn structure, but black is also quite okay. Only one weakness on e5. Black will develop the bishop, double the rooks, and more or less it's equal. More or less.
I agree. I think so. Yeah. Let's see what's happening. If black played king h8, and after that we'll just have to see. Yeah, Luca Maroni, I'm not sure how what his age is. I think he's about 18 years old and about a 2600 player, I believe, already. So yeah, that's like an indicator. Let's remind everyone we have to do this a few times. The ratings that you see next to the names are actually not the official feeder ratings. Those are the chess.com ratings, so those are not representative of their actual strength. So keep that in mind, everybody, when you're looking at the ratings. Right, we've got one result, by the way, on the last board. So that means that Maria Palma from Italy won her game against Tala Al Nasser from Jordan. Yeah, this looks like a very nice mate. Yep.
Not right. Bad. Definitely not bad.
And all right, let's move on to another game. This is Nico Georgiadis versus Benjamin Bok. Benjamin Bok is the second board player of the Netherlands versus Switzerland. D4, is that a good move? I guess so, yeah. So this was the position and now D4 played. So what are the advantages of playing D4 in positions like this?
I am, to be honest, I am a bit surprised because I think it's still the theory while white is down to 3 minutes only. So a d4, black is trying to get rid of this isolated pawn. And if black manages just, you know, to go for all these massive trades on the d4 and Maybe they can just equalize the position, but the problem is that black's bishop is still on c8, so white is a little bit ahead in development, and perhaps white has some tempis to actually exploit it. After d4, the moves that are coming to my mind, of course, first is to take on d4, but besides taking on d4, another possibility is to play knight a4, taking the c5 bishop. Maybe that's also a good option.
That's actually what happened on in the game, so we can take a look at that. Knight f4 with tempo, attacking the bishop. Bishop d6, taking, taking. Knight
taking
takes d4,
knight.
And now this is the current position. So obviously, don't take on d4, everybody, because then we've got a nice discovery. So, but I would definitely play him with like knight g4 here.
Knight g4 or bishop g4. Also,
yeah,
bishop
g4
after f3. Can we take on d4? Still, maybe not. But maybe yes. King h1 and rook d8.
Yeah, rook d8. Wow, that's
knight.
Nice. Yeah. So the point is, once again, that if the bishop moves, then we've got bishop takes h7, winning the queen. But rook a8 is a knight in between move because the bishop on d3 is attacked. So. Yeah, this looks good for black. So f3 is not possible, but probably white needs to play a move like queen d2, I suppose.
Queen d2 or queen b3. If queen d2, maybe just rook a8.
Yeah,
and it's
next
not so
move
clear how to defend this d4 pawn. Oh, draw was agreed. We don't
right.
have, you know, to break our head trying to find the solution because, yeah, maybe.
Yeah,
maybe it's just about equal.
Okay, yeah, well, let's take a look at one of the big legends who's playing in this tournament. We've got Alexei Shirov with the white pieces playing against Ilya Sivash of the Estonia country. White is a pawn down, but the one thing that strikes me is the king on g8 and the rook on h8. Those two cannot move here. I'm wondering if white has enough here. White is also down on time, 3 minutes versus six. And yeah, I don't know. White does have a lot of compensation with the knight, with it not a red, a green knight on d6. Maybe h4, h5 comes to mind. This queen b4, just some moves, but I don't know. Black wants to play h6, king h7, and say, I'm all right, I'm doing okay.
Yeah, but it's still two moves, and I believe white definitely has enough compensation, at least for equality. But can they ask for more? This is the question. Rook b7 was played, attacking the e7 knight. So now the question is where this knight will move, to c6 or to f5. In fact, after knight f5, I believe black doesn't really threaten to take the d6 knight. Knight f5 played on the board. Because if they take this d6 knight, then the pawn will move to d6, and this will be a very dangerous pawn. But if white place knight f5, of course that would be a good knight trade for black, so I don't believe knight f5 will be played. White will keep the knight on d6.
I think so too. Yeah, the one thing that is maybe helpful for white is that the bishop is temporarily off g6, therefore h6 and king h7 is not possible because the rook on f7 will fall. That might be something to keep in mind for the white player, but I don't know. I guess I would start with trying to make a move like queen b4 work, because you've got rook b8 mating ideas. But after queen b4, it's simply h6, I believe. And not much is going on with that.
And
unless
you have
you
to take
to...
care about your bishop. Maybe bishop d3.
Yeah,
but bishop d3, now knight d6. This is the problem.
Yeah, because you're attacking the b7. Rook. So if you take here, you can take here in between.
Yeah.
So not bishop d3. What about simply taking, anyways, taking and maybe a move like bishop h5?
Bishop h5, then queen e7 is coming. Some ideas of that kind, yeah.
Yeah, maybe. Maybe this is a way to play for white. But I keep feeling that even you can play here king h7, I believe that would be fine, because if you take the pawn, The rook is coming in. All the pawns are protected. So this maybe is just fine for black. Although I am really worried about queen e7 ideas. But for example, after rook h8, bishop goes here. You do have bishop d3 ideas perhaps at some point.
Yes,
No.
true. Let's see. Maybe some
Yes.
moves were played. Did they? Oh,
Yep,
yeah.
it's
Knight f4
it.
was actually played. I am a bit surprised. I said that wouldn't be played, but it was played. And queen b4 we have on the board. Or it's from our. Is it from our analysis or
This
that was played?
is currently on the
Ah, that
board.
was played.
Yeah, rook
Nice.
h6.
Nice guess, Ruan.
Yeah, thank you, thank you. Yeah, I think we have to play knight f5 because, like you said, no, because the bishop was on g6 protecting the f7 pawn. So yeah, white can try to make use of this. Actually, I'm thinking is h5 maybe a bit better, because then you stop bishop h5. And with queen e7, then bishop g6 was my idea, but yeah,
Bishop
what?
d3.
Yeah, bishop d3 ideas are still in the air. Well, okay, I'm gonna be a bit fancy. Rook h6.
Oh my God,
Rook
yeah.
takes takes.
Looks
Ooh.
bad, but not so bad, yeah. So maybe now bishop d6 because you're not threatening to take my bishop on d3, but rook h6. Cute
Yep.
move, cute defense.
Well, I don't know if it works. It looks very. Oh, it's actually H5 is on the board.
Wow.
Am I gonna guess this correctly? That would be a miracle. No. Rook F8 is, by the way, also a very possible move. Yeah. Looks.
No. No, we have to see this happening. Yeah, rook h6, please. Rook h6, but maybe it's the only move, so rook h6.
Yeah, I don't think it's good though. I
Yay!
think white. Oh boy, Ilya, we think alike. We think alike, you and I. Yeah. It's
I
not
think
good though.
Alexei Shiro is very much surprised by this maneuver.
It looks great though. This rook on g6 looks awesome. Protecting everything, you know. But on the other hand, this is still very dangerous. I'm not sure what to do after. Yeah, queen f3 is, for example, a good move attacking h5. I don't like this. I don't like this idea. It's very creative, but I think that black should have played something else, something more solid. Just play h6, for example, like we mentioned before.
H6, you mean King H6, right?
No, I mean instead
Yeah.
of h5 and bishop g6. Yeah, but the king
But what
h7
about
could
King
be.
H6 now? It's not so bad.
We're just going to continue in the creative road. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, if you start this way, you have to continue this way. You said A, you should say B.
Yeah. Oh boy. It's hard to find games sometimes. But let's move on to another game. We can check this. I think Shirov is slightly in the driving seat, but of course, there's still a lot of work to be done to convert a game like this. We've got some results in the match, by the way. Monica Ruiz won with the white pieces. I think the queen is trapped over here, so that's.
Oh, look. No, let's stay for a while in this position. Yeah, just queen on d3 is trapped. Queen on the center of the board. Be careful if you move your queen too often in the opening, because this may happen. That's it.
There you go. All right, and we've got a result between. Yeah, Benjamin Bok and Nico Georgiadis. We already
This
saw
we
that
had,
one.
yes.
We've got here. Yeah.
Daniel Dvirny beating Mansour Samer.
Yep. So this looks absolutely winning. Yep. Let me. I just got noticed that Jordan van Foreest is looking. Oh boy, not that hot in the. His position against Noah Studer. So this is board one, the Netherlands versus Switzerland here. What's going on? Knight
Studer is
g6 being played.
two pawns
He
down, king
takes.
c3, let's say. Knight e5, knight a7, knight f3, but it's two pawns up for white, should be winning.
Yeah, they're still on one side though. Maybe there are still some. Drawing chances, but I don't believe so actually. D6 looks interesting, by the way. With knight c6, next d78. Maybe. Well, d6, knight e5, controlling everything.
But then the king moves, king d4, king d5.
Yeah, this
Maybe
looks.
there are some chances, but it's very, very difficult to save this game.
Yeah, this looks very good for Switzerland. Right, let's see. Actually, I think another legend of the game. Well, Zhao Guangpeng with black pieces against Lena Georgescu. So, okay, black is going for it with bishop h3. Just bishop
Lena
f3, it seems.
Georgescu is the sister of Nico Georgadis, so we see the brother and sister playing for the same team, and it's nice to see family joining the Olympiad. And according to computer simulation, she's doing great in this game, but she has to find some defense. Bishop f3 is probably the only move.
Yeah, and then the knight has to move.
The knight has
Knight
to move, but the question
seven.
where? And then bishop f4.
Queen has to go. Then there are some tricks maybe over c file. Maybe that's the problem.
Also, d5 pawn will be hanging. So, or
Yeah.
simply something simple like bishop g3 is also fine for white.
Yeah, bishop g3. Materials equal. Seems that we've got a trick in the position. The computer is overexcited for the white position here. I think we have to start with bishop f4. Let's. Okay, it's on the board. Queen has to go. It has to go either here, here, or here. Okay, well, we've got our answer. Queen e6. Trying to find a win here for white, but.
But
Oh,
where to
maybe,
go after e1?
yeah, rook e1. Oh, wow, okay. Let's
Play
answer that
defense moves.
question first. What happens after rook e1? I think the queen goes to f7, has to go there.
So that after rook e8, you can take with the queen, but then simply bishop d5.
Yeah, this looks horrible. The bishops are dominating for white. The knight on d7 isn't doing anything. This looks really great. No sacrifices. I believe because white always has bishop g3 as a protective measure. Yeah, queen e6 might not have been the best move, but okay, white did not go into this, but played rook fc1, c6, bishop g3, and okay, queen f4. That's a simple and straightforward idea, looking good for white. Unfortunately.
Maybe it's still okay, yes, but
It's
maybe rook
fair.
f1 was stronger.
Maybe, yeah.
Bishop g4, queen f4 played.
Oh,
Knight
what?
f5.
Isn't this over now? Oh, the bishop is protected twice. I did not see that.
Yes, but queen c7 mate
Yep.
was a serious threat.
King d8, a move you don't want to play. So that's why knight e5 on the board now. Takes, takes.
Bishop
Okay.
g4.
White has some, black has some compensation, but a piece is just way too much, yeah.
Yeah, bishop g4, then move the queen, should be winning for white.
Yeah, maybe here. Right, not looking too great. Let me try and find something, an interesting
Something
position.
better.
Okay. I almost found a knight on a1, but it's unfortunately on h1.
Ah, the knight we were missing, yes, yesterday.
Yeah, I'm still looking for that a little bit, but unfortunately not yet. Okay, let me try to find something interesting. This looks interesting.
This just looks not so good for white.
Yeah, white is just, what is it? A pawn? No, it's actually equal. Aye, wait, 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 wait.
Equal, I think knight e5 just makes things worse for white. Yeah, because after the straight bishop h1, bishop
Yeah,
h1, and queen g2.
yeah. Looks like it. Oh, oops.
Oh, queen e4.
Queen takes bishop h1. F3 needs to be
f3,
played. Then after
bishop f3.
taking. Yeah, weak king and an opposite colored bishop. So weak king is very often the decisive factor. So this could
Or you
very
know,
well already be winning for black.
Yeah, sorry, maybe you could even make it in a better way, not bishop h1 immediately, but rook d1.
Okay,
And then let's say bishop e3 or somewhere. Now rook a1. Oh, you want me? I wanted to take the rook on a1, the
Oh, sorry. Yeah, take first,
bishop
then bishop
h1. And now
h1.
if f3, we can take with the queen on f3. And
Yeah, problem is maybe king f1 is now an idea, but I don't think so. Yeah.
Like in f1. No,
No.
I don't believe you can escape. But maybe your suggestion of bishop h1 immediately after, yeah, rook d1 here, bishop h1, f3, queen f3.
F3, queen f3,
That's
queen
it.
g2. Looks winning for black. Let's see if we get that on the board. Not yet. Or do we? No. Yeah, bishop g2 on the board. It's also interesting. Bishop h1. Okay, more or less the same idea, yeah. But now after
But now
f3, queen takes
f3,
a frame.
queen f3, queen e2,
Queen takes g3,
queen takes
perhaps.
g3, king
Or rook
h1.
d1. Rook d1 looks winning, actually.
Oh yeah. Well,
Yeah, more
maybe
or less.
that prolonged the game, but it's still winning. Oh, this was played, yeah?
This is now the current position on the board. I just skipped ahead because we're also in time trouble, so let's stick to what's happening in the game. I think Black missed some chances. Yeah, I mean,
Yeah,
I
yeah.
think still it should be winning, but yeah,
But he's
looks
also
like.
winning on the spot.
Yeah, exactly. So what Black missed the win there, but yeah, so now she has to fight for in time trouble for the win here. Still looking good. All right, this is also an interesting position. We've got Luka Moroni with Black facing off against Malek Saif. We saw this game earlier as well, and now there's queen's on the board. The king needs to go to f2, if I'm not mistaken. Queen takes h3. Queen
Queen
d5.
d4, maybe.
Queen d4. Yeah, was that looks over? Yeah, more or less after queen d4.
Maybe not
Maybe
like
not.
rook g7.
Now, Luka Moroni has a lot more time than his opponent. So 1 minute versus 15 seconds. Rook e8, king h7.
It's
Well,
far
it
from
looks safe
over.
enough. So it looks safe enough, yeah. F6, though. But
F6, but it blocked the diagonal, so now the rook can move.
there are lots of checks in the position as well. Oh, Black needs to spend some time here. What could be the best check to make use of? Well, you almost had mate in two, but there's a queen on d4. That's not true. I don't see anything. The queen on d4 is magnificent there. It's protecting everything. I don't know.
Oh,
Is
it's not
white
an easy
over
task.
pushing though?
Maybe queen g3 and then even rook f7 looks a bit passive.
I'm not sure if that works because then rook e8, let's put it on the board. Rook
Rook
e8.
e8 and queen e4. Yeah, queen g6, rook
And
h8.
rook h8, yeah.
That was not a good suggestion.
Well, it's something that crosses everybody's mind, also mine. Rook g2, I kind of like actually because now at least Black can try to exchange a pair of rooks. That's a safe idea, I think. Queen g3, also possible. King d1. Well,
King one or king
this is
two?
pretty interesting. Rook takes, king takes, queen g5. Black just keeps checking. Why not?
Yeah, I think it's better to keep the rook as long as we can. Rook g1 now.
Yeah, well, white has f7 ideas. I'm not sure that this is going well. He needs to
Queen
trade queen
g6
somehow.
or queen f5?
King b3.
King b3, rook g3.
Oh, king b4 is maybe. No, c5 doesn't work.
Rook g4, no?
Yeah, but then f7.
No, this one
Well,
here.
rook d4 is actually
And
pretty.
now rook e7, maybe.
It's simply a draw. Rook
Maybe
e8.
it's perpetual. Yes.
It's a perpetual.
Because if black goes to g6, then there is a rook g7. But no, black is trying to play for a win.
King f7, king f8, maybe.
King f7, king f8. So rook g7 now.
Yeah, rook g7 should be a draw.
No.
No, king f7, king f8, and black wins. Oh boy. Yeah.
Oh yes.
That was painful. Ay, ay, ay. That was a draw. So black could have played, white could have played rook g7. And after taking, taking, it should be a draw. But I think black has the easier play because there's a clear target and a clear pawn that can run still. Well, white still has to work a little bit. But yeah,
Yes,
this would have
five.
prolonged the match. And in the game, it was this. And now black is simply a queen up. You hate to see it, folks. All right. Do we have something interesting left? Not really. All the games are more or less coming to a close. We've got this game between Bruno and, well, there are some. Oh, here we go. Bruno Andre Leite Martins versus David Stefania, but it's a draw. Okay, let's move on to the next one. Yeah. The games are coming to a close, everybody. You can see the results a little bit on the left. We are updating those as much as we can. And we actually already see a big result for Spain, winning 6-0 versus Estonia, and Jordan losing 0-4 already against Italy. And the Netherlands going well, and North Macedonia also going. Yeah, what to say about this position? It's just don't play a move like Rook H3, for example. Mouse slips like those are possible still, but if you don't do that, then you should be winning with black, I believe. Is it that easy though? King F3, how do you continue here?
How do I continue? Maybe just bring the rook to e8 if white it's a draw.
It's a draw, repetition of moves. I think black should have played bishop d4, king a7, and then see what's next. Well, that was surprising. I didn't expect a repetition of moves there.
Maybe rook e8 and just f3 or.
Ah, that's actually maybe easier, you know. Yeah, that looks winning. If rook c2, maybe now simply bishop d4. You could also maybe try and go for the pawn ending, but bishop
Yeah,
d4
just
looks
some
better.
waiting move, I think.
Yeah, king a7 next, f3. Yeah, looks very good for black. So yeah, unfortunately, a draw for black with a repetition of moves. But let's move on. There are still, I think there's one game left, and that's this one. Well,
How
this
did
looks.
actually Jordan Van Forest play versus Noel Studer, because it's 2.5, 2.5 in the match between Switzerland and Netherlands.
Yeah, everything is over, but let me check if there are still some. If I
Yes.
can find that result. But okay, Jordan should have lost that game against Noah Studer. It was 2 points down, I believe. So, wait, does that mean that the Netherlands has lost
Yeah, that's
that
why I'm
game?
asking because it's like very important game. While in all the other matches we have clear results. Spain beat Estonia 6-0, Italy is winning versus Jordan 5-0, and yeah, maybe even 6-0. Slovenia won the match versus Portugal because it was already 4-0. And North Macedonia won versus Albania because it's already 4-1. And yeah, Netherlands 2.5 to 2.5. And yeah, Jordan, how did he play?
Yeah,
He
well,
lost 3.5 to 2.5.
actually we can ask him ourselves because everybody, we are going on a short break, and afterwards we'll have Grandmaster Jordan van Vlees back with us to tell a little bit about how his game went. And we'll ask him, of course, a bunch of other questions as well. So don't go anywhere, and we'll be back in a few seconds.
Maybe not the best question about his game. Let's prepare some better questions, and maybe actually chat will help us with that. Please write down your questions, questions you would like to ask Jordan Van Forest, a very young and talented player from the Netherlands. So we will be back soon. See you shortly.
There's no shower.
But Roland, it would be funny. Oh, hello from the shower.
Well, I don't think chess.com would like that very much, but
they don't care. We can do anything if, as long as we keep it a little bit general, you know.
Okay, so then next time, guys.
I'm sorry.
Next time I'll be from the shower then.
Yeah, the player was about to take a shower, but
please
we
don't.
Asked him
please
to join
don't.
The press conference, a short interview, so please, if you want, and then you can continue doing whatever you like.
Mm-hmm. Actually, there is...
Well, okay. Stop you. Oh, we are live? We're actually live. Okay, I didn't know it. We were just having an interesting conversation there, of course, with Jordan. My buddy, and of course, my ex-co-host, actually. We actually did a commentary section before here. So, okay, now officially, we were just talking nicely, but let's go in the official broadcast. Hey, Jordan, welcome to the broadcast. Thank you for coming over. And unfortunate about your loss. Yeah.
I didn't get your question, but hi to you too. My internet may not be the best. So what did you ask again?
Oh, I just asked you a little bit about your game. It wasn't actually a question, just a general setup. But So unfortunate about your game. How are you feeling about that right now?
Yeah. It's a pity because due to this loss, we lost the match as well. So it's not good. But my opponent played well, and I think I just made one mistake and then it was immediately lost. So it happens. I was actually more annoyed about, well, about personally my second game of today, because I was playing a beautiful game and then I mixed up two moves in my head, and then by accident I played the wrong one, and I didn't win that one as well. So, but anyway, our team is still in it to qualify to the next stage, I think. So no need to be too pessimistic yet.
Yeah, absolutely. You still have chances, of course. Yeah. By the way, we Anne and I were actually joking that after round four, we saw that the Netherlands won in round four, and we also saw that Anish wasn't participating. So maybe it was because Anish was actually not participating that you guys were doing well, you know?
No. This was planned. This was planned beforehand. Anish had to travel, so that's why he couldn't play. But. Yeah. I have to say his first day also wasn't the best, of course. So so far we are struggling in the event. You can certainly say that. At least Anish and me. But I think our other players are playing decently, just it's us messing it up. So we gotta start playing better.
Well, yeah, one thing I noticed actually was that the women are doing absolutely very well right now. I think that Peng scored, well, she lost her game, I believe, in this match. But before that, she was doing very well as Rosa Ratsma and Anna Haast, I think. So, those are good players to rely on in the team, I guess. Yeah.
Our female players are playing well. So we are banking on them, and the weak spot is the men section. So we'll see if we can do better there tomorrow.
Yeah, of course.
I think you have a very good team and you have great chances to qualify. So please don't get upset. Good luck in the next games. And actually, I have got a question to you in the chat. Do you get nervous when you play versus stronger opponents versus the best players in the world? How do you feel?
Yeah. I definitely get more and more nervous. Also, I get nervous, you know, when here I see a high chess.com rating. It means I have to watch out. But in general, yeah, when you're playing the strong players in the world, you're nervous. So here I haven't played any world-class players yet, but still I've played some, at least a couple of grandmasters, I think three. So these are also tough guys. And you know, it's a tough event. So lots of nerves.
Yeah, I know. I'm a chess player myself, so I know what you feel. Yes, and there are some players who actually prefer to play versus stronger opponents, while there are some that prefers to play the lower-rated opponents or the opponents of their level. Mm-hmm. But personally, for me, yeah, I get more tensed when I play versus stronger opponents, and when I'm facing someone.
For me, it's like I would love to play against Jorda. That is always that's always a lot of fun for me. A lot of good games, a lot of good results, right, Jordan? Do you remember our last game?
yes, of course, yes. It wasn't good. It wasn't good. You were. I prefer not playing you. In general, I completely agree with what Anna says. I also get more nervous when I play stronger players, but it's also more interesting. So yes, completely agree there.
Yeah. Sure. And your brother is also in the team, right?
No, he is playing. Actually, his tournament just finished, but he was playing an over-the-board tournament. Yes, these are still going on in Italy. So he was playing there, and that's why he didn't play. But we have anyway strong junior boards, but my brother is not playing this time.
Yeah, maybe just you could say in the end, because you have a chess family, you have brother, sister, they are all playing chess. Please, a few words about that.
Yes, we have. So you mentioned my brother, Lucas, and in the team, also in this team, in the Olympia team, my sister is playing on the girls' board. So, we are definitely a chess family, and I have a few more other siblings, and they don't play chess as much, but they still enjoy the game. And it's funny because my parents, they're not really into chess, so it's funny that we got into chess ourselves.
That's really cool.
Maybe not your parents, but I do believe you have a grandfather or an over grandfather.
Yes. I have. I don't know the English word, but the grandfather of my grandfather was also, and his brother were also chess players. So a few generations passed, and now we are playing chess again. But I don't. I believe I'm not the only one in this school with a successful chess family. So. Anna, of course, has a very good sister as well. And I don't know about the rest, but yeah.
Yeah. Right. I think that's it for now. Thank you, Jordi, once again to come on the broadcast with us and answering a few questions. And of course, I think the Netherlands is right now in third place. So you guys still are perfectly in the race to qualify for the next division. So yeah, still going strong. So yeah, thank you once again for coming on the broadcast, and good luck for the rest of the rounds, of course.
Okay, keep it up. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.
Good luck. Hope to see you in the top division. But first of all, yes, you need to win some matches in division two.
Yes. Okay, see you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Hello, guys, and we are back still for a little bit of coverage because we will go on a big break in just a little bit. But what we still have to give you, of course, after this wonderful interview of Jordi van Vereest, is the results of the Pool C, and of course, also the results of Pool D. They played one round as well while we were covering the round six of Pool C. So here you go, Pool C. Spain winning 6-0, Jordan winning, not winning actually, losing 0-6 against Italy, 5-1 for Slovenia against Portugal, 3.5, 2.5 for Switzerland, a big upset, I would say, good job for Switzerland, and Albania losing their match against North Macedonia. So what does that mean for the standings? Well, you asked it. We are going to deliver. Here you go. Spain in first place with 11 points. Italy with 9. Netherlands with 8. So no biggie. They lost their match, but they are still in the race for qualification very much. The last three rounds will be decisive, but they have got one of the strongest teams to qualify. So I'm pretty confident that they will actually do that. So yeah, that will be it for us for now. We will be back, everybody, in 1 hour for more coverage. Of course, we will take a look at pool D and pool E, and we'll try to get more interesting guests into the broadcast so that we can have a little chat with them and how they feel about the tournament as well. That'll be it for now. So don't go anywhere. Stretch your legs. Well, go everywhere, actually, but be back here in 1 hour with more coverage of the online 2020 Olympia.
Yes, we are having a break, and yes, the viewer, you might also have a 1 hour break, and let's meet all together once again just in 1 hour. Hope to see all of you. See you.
Yep.